Hello and welcome to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson, and folks, we are going to have an excellent game for you tonight here at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City. The number 2 seeded Fairfield Stags are playing the number 5 seeded St. Peter's Peacocks for a chance to move on to the big dance, the NCAA tournament, tonight on this Saturday evening. The men's have a chance to go on to the tournament.
First time since 1997 looking to make history under once interim head coach Chris Casey, now official head coach of your Fairfield University Stags, who started 1-6, do I remind you. It was looking dark, but Chris Casey turned this team around. The power of positivity was alive and in full force, and the Stags are right where they want to be in the championship game.
So, Andrew, before we dive into what has happened or what's going to happen tonight, let's look at how we've gotten here. What is the road that St. Peter's has taken to the championship game?
Well, St. Peter's is the 5 seed, and that 4-5 seed matchup is always a dogfight against Ryder, who came into the tournament winning 7 in a row. They shut down Mervyn James, MAAC Player of the Year, all-first team nominee, to a poor shooting night, uncharacteristic of him. St. Peter's won that dogfight. I believe the score was
50 to 48.
Yes, you are correct. Then let's fast forward to yesterday. It was another dogfight against Quinnipiac, the top-seeded Bobcats. Matt Belonk, Player of the Year in the MAAC, another first-team selection. Peacocks were a grinding, grit-and-grind game. One on a buzzer beater by number 35, Muhammad So. Peacocks survived by the skin of their teeth in a grueling game, to say the least.
And they have gotten some massive performances along the way. Michael Houge, going back to the quarterfinals against Ryder, he had a career-high 20 points in the win to go along with 8 rebounds, 3 blocks. Marcus Randolph had 10 points on 3-of-5 shooting from deep in that victory. And with 6 seconds left in that game, Ryder had a chance to either tie the game or take the lead, and the defense held strong for the Peacocks. So that set up with a date with the number 1 seeded Quinnipiac. And they held Quinnipiac to their lowest scoring output of the season. 60 points is all Quinnipiac scored. St. Peter's hit 62, and as you mentioned, Muhammad Sow with the tap-in to put him with the buzzer beater. Sow had 15 points that game. That was his season high.
How do you stop a prolific high-flying offense such as Quinnipiac? Through stout defense. 7 blocks versus Quinnipiac. Matt Blanc only shot 5 of 19 from the field. Very uncharacteristic game of him. That's an entire credit to the entire organization there. You mentioned Muhammad So led the Peacocks with 15 points. He shot 75% from the field overall and hit 3 3-pointers. So the big man getting it done on all facets of the game.
And Andrew, you brought up the stingy Peacock defense. The Peacocks defense is ranked 14th in the nation in scoring, giving up just over 64 points per game on average. And they are led by junior Latrell Reed. Latrell Reed, third-team All-MAC honoree, named MAAC Defensive Player of the Year. Now, before we go any further with the Peacocks, let's flip the switch to the Stags. The Stags, what was their road to the championship game?
Just like St. Peter's, it's been 2 barn burners. Absolutely, you cannot say anything less. First, let's go to Iona, their quarterfinal matchup. We're 0-2 versus them in the regular season. They prevailed 68-63 behind Jalen Leach's 22 and Caleb Fields contributed 20. An absolute grit and grind game. Stags prevailed.
That win snapped a 7-game losing streak for the Stags against the Gales and marked Fairfield's first postseason win over Iona since 2012. And as you mentioned, Leach, phenomenal, 22 points. 15 of his 22 came in the second half of that one. Alexis Yetna made his first start in the quarterfinals. He would also make his second career start in the semifinals against Marist.
Yes, and that game against Marist, absolute thriller. Marist was up by as much as 11 in the first half. However, the Stags bended but did not break. Caleb Fields, there's no other way to put it. He was a savior for this offense. Had 22 points on 8 of 18 shooting. Jalen Leach, who had a lackluster first half with no points, bounced back in a big way with 13 in the second half. However, the Stags struggled from the court overall as a team, shooting 39% from the field and just 21% from 3.
And as you mentioned, Caleb Fields with a Herculean effort. He played every single second. He played all 40 last night. Now, Caleb Fields on the year has 100 career 103 pointers this season, with four more, or actually his next three will be his 100th three-pointer on the year. 104 is the school record for most threes made in a single season. Watch for Caleb Fields to try and continue his hot shooting. And just to talk about their comeback against Marist, they held Marist without a field goal for a span of 9 minutes and 42 seconds in the second half last night, and they get contributions for everywhere. As you mentioned, Jalen Leach was not very strong last night until the second half. Freshman Peyton Smith came off the bench and scored 9 big points for the Stags.
And Peyton Smith was honestly an X factor in that game last night, getting it done in the paint when filling in on the bench for Yedna. He was injury riddled a little bit throughout the course of February, March, and has seen his minutes diminish over the course of the season. Nonetheless, he played some of his most clutch basketball in the clutchest time.
One of the keys to victory for the Stags in their game against Marist last night is they won the turnover battle 13-6, and the Stags had an 18-2 edge over the Marist Red Foxes in points off of turnovers.
And given the scrappy nature of St. Peter's team, it's going to be another one of those games that's going to be decided off turnovers and whether or not the Stags can capitalize off those turnovers.
Stay right with us here at Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. We're going to be right back previewing tonight's championship game. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio on 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jamison. Andrew, this will be the third time that these two teams have met this year. Fairfield 2-0 against St. Peter's on the season.
Yeah, and Fairfield against St. Peter's 2-0 on the season, as you just said. Both of those games have been dogfights, though. Going back to January 19th when they played at Leo D. Mahoney Arena, Jalen Leach tallied a career-high 29 points. They shot 50% from the field as a team, 25% from three. Important to note that Yetna did not play and Bleachmore left early with an injury. But how did they prevail? They won the rebounding battle 33-32, and Bryson Goodine was clutch off the bench with 16 points.
And in the second matchup was in Jersey City, Fairfield won 64-62. Caleb Fields, Jalen Leach each had 17 in the victory, while James Johns Jr. had 11 in the victory. The Stags shot 50% from the field in that game against St. Peter's as well, 36.8% from three, and just about 62% from the line. Now, in that second game, star player for the Peacocks, Corey Washington, did not play. So Roy Clark stepped up in his spot. He had 21 points while Marcus Randolph had 19 points in the loss.
And some of these Peacocks cannot go overlooked if you're Fairfield's defense. A lot of guys can step up, and March is where legends are made after all. Roy Clark had 21, as you said. Randolph had 19. Just throw Corey Washington in there, and this Peacocks offense is very dangerous.
And Corey Washington, the main playmaker for the Peacocks. He's an All-MAC first-team honoree. He built off his All-MAC rookie team season last season. He's had a breakout year for the Peacocks this year. He's led the team in scoring with 16.8 points per game. To boot, he's also leading the team with 6.4 rebounds per game. The 6'6 forward has scored 20 points or more in a game 9 times and had 4 double-doubles on the year. On top of that, he's earned a MAAC Player of the Week nominee. Now, Andrew, what are the keys to the game for St. Peter's tonight?
For St. Peter's, it's a matter about quality over quantity. This team is a scrappy team, as I mentioned earlier. They are not the highest offensive shooting team, as they are toward the lower end of the spectrum in points per game within the MAAC. However, this team is, their defense is absolutely elite. They will wear you down quickly. They did it against Quinnipiac. They did it against Ryder. And they have done it from time to time versus Fairfield throughout the course of the regular season.
Now for Fairfield, what are your keys to the game for the Stags?
Fairfield needs to a hot start offensively and set the tone with a high-flying and prolific pace. The Stags have struggled from three-point range in both games versus Iona and Marist. And throughout the course of the regular season, we have observed that this team somewhat lives and dies by the three-point field goal. When they're on, but when they're off, it can get ugly from time to time. So they need to be consistent, and they need to be consistent from start to finish.
Fairfield as a team ranks at least fourth in every single category in the MAAC this season, but they are first in fast break points, threes made, and the three-point percentage. You are absolutely correct in the fact that the Stags live and die by the three, and the fact that they're here despite not shooting a three, well, the last two games says a lot about them.
And we mentioned Fairfield being fortunate yesterday in a sense. Fairfield's fortunate that they were down two. Mind you, I'm not. Jalen Leach did not score in that first half at all. How did they do it? Through depth. The last thing you can afford if you're the Stags is to give the Peacocks any wiggle room and let them back into this game, because they are just too scrappy and physical of a team to go not go down without a fight.
Fairfield overall in MAAC championship games as a program, 3-6. They most recently appeared in the conference final in 2021, and Fairfield's three conference titles came in 1986, 1987, and 1997. Now, Andrew, last year, and in fact, the last few seasons, these two teams have collided in the postseason, and St. Peter's sent Fairfield home in last year's MAAC tournament in the first round.
Yes, they did, and St. Peter's defeated Fairfield in the first round 70-52. So you'd have to think Fairfield is kind of playing with a chip on their shoulder in a sense. However, these two teams are entirely different from what they were last year. Fairfield has a new coach. St. Peter's has a completely new identity. We're in for a treat tonight, Ryan.
This season will be the fourth straight season that Fairfield and St. Peter's have gone head-to-head in the postseason. However, the Stags and the Peacocks have not met in the MAAC final. These two programs have met in the MAAC postseason 15 times. St. Peter's is 8-7 overall against Fairfield in those games. Now, Andrew, these two programs have played 130 games against each other. They are 65-65 all time. Tonight, whoever wins this game will go 66-65 in the all-time matchup, and more importantly, clinch the MAAC championship.
I mean, I don't think you can write a better script than what we have here tonight.
And look, we know the kind of magic that St. Peter possesses. After their magical 2021-2022 season that saw them with a surprise run to the Elite Eight, head coach Shaheen Holloway left and took the Seton Hall job, and in has come Bashir Mason. Bashir Mason in his second season, after he was previously at Wagner for a very successful decade, where he led the team to three Northeastern Conference regular season titles, posting a 165 and a 130 record over that time on Staten Island. You know the Peacocks are going to be prepared tonight.
And you see this reoccurring theme of coaches from year one to year two, the dramatic change that can happen. We see it with Coach Carly Tebow Dedonis, who just led her Fairfield Stags to an NCAA championship for the MAAC, and they are going dancing. Chris Casey and his Stags are hoping for the same story here tonight.
Andrew, you brought up the women's program, the woman earlier in an absolutely thrilling overtime victory over Niagara has won the MAAC, and now the Fairfield men have a chance to do something incredibly, incredibly special in MAAC's history. Fairfield looks to join Loyola in 1994, Manhattan in 2003, and Iona in 2016 and last season in 2023 as institutions to have won both the MAAC men's and women's basketball championships in the same season. Now the men, the Fairfield are looking to end one of the longest MAAC championship droughts among current membership. Canisius last won the MAAC in 1996, and as Andrew mentioned earlier, the Fairfield last won the MAAC in 1997. Stay right with us, folks. We're gonna have starting lineups, the national anthem, and tip-off coming next. Don't go anywhere here at Fairfield University, Student Radio, 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson. We are moments away from tip-off. We just had our national anthem played on the world's largest instrument, the organ, here at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall. We just had our starting lineups introduced for the Stags. We have grad student guard Caleb Fields. We have senior guard Jalen Leach. Junior guard Jasper Floyd. Forward Alexis Yetna. And senior Louis Bleachmore. for St. Peter's University. They're starting with senior Latrell Reed, junior guard Marcus Randolph, forward Corey Washington, junior forward Michael Hogue, and center from 6'9", from Dakar, Senegal, Mohamed Sou. Andrew, we are going to have a great one tonight. The Stags are wearing their white jerseys for the third consecutive game. The Stags in their white, the lettering and the numbering red. They have gray piping down the side of their shorts. On the flip side, St. Peter's wearing blue shorts, white socks, with a blue uniform with lettering that is gray and white.
It's been a phenomenal tournament up to this point, Ryan, from the atmosphere to the crowd, to the fans, to the pep band, to the cheerleaders. I expect nothing less than a phenomenal game here tonight between two talented teams.
We have a packed house here at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall. There's going to be a raucous crowd tonight here in Atlantic City on this Saturday evening. We thank you for spending part of your Saturday evening here with us at 88.5 Fairfield University Student Radio. Louis Bleachmore and the Stags have taken the court. We're waiting on St. Peter's. St. Peter's, led by Bashir Mason, looking to get back to the tournament for the first time since their magical run to the Elite Eight in 2021 and 2022. The Stags, looking to get back to the tournament for the first time this century. They have not made the tournament since 1997. They lost in the championship game just a couple of years ago, and now they're looking to get revenge on the team that knocked them out of the first round last season.
They have slayed one dragon in Iona. They're looking to slay another in St. Peter's here tonight.
This should be a good one, folks. This should be a really, really good one. And fun fact, this is the third consecutive day where St. Peter's has played a game. They played Thursday night, they played Friday night, and now they're playing tonight. They did not play back-to-back games all season long, let alone back-to-back-to-back games. Now, Fairfield, on the other hand, in August, played back-to-back-to-back games in Costa Rica, but that was back in August of 2023. And they played back-to-back games this season, but that was in November before conference play started. Something to keep an eye on and something to see how St. Peter's will respond tonight. So St. Peter's breaks the huddle.
And you know, that 24-hour window period that Fairfield had for their semifinal matchup paid great dividends as Marist was coming off a grueling victory to Niagara. Both teams are banged up a little bit from hard-fought victories. I think everyone's at even strength, though, given the circumstances.
So on the tip-off will be Mohamed Sou for St. Peter's. On the tip for the Fairfield Stags, Louis Bleachmore. The Stags will be going from my right to the left, and St. Peter's from the left to the right. Bleachmore is ready. Sou is ready. Atlantic City is ready. This place is packed. The environment, unbelievable. And we are almost off. The tip. Won by St. Peter's, and we are off here in Atlantic City. Dribbling up the court now, Latrell Reed, the MAAC Defensive Player of the Year, guarded by Caleb Fields. He dribbles to his right, drives to the paint. Lee tries to strip. He kicks it to the near corner, Randolph. Marcus Randolph passes it over to the top, Corey Washington. Inside now, inside the Hogue. Hogue back out to Washington. Washington pumps, drives. His layup is good. Good defense by Floyd, but better, a strong layup.
Better defense, better offense there over better defense. Washington will not be denied.
First point of the game for St. Peter's. Jalen Leach on the top of the key. Passes over to Fields. Fields with 22 last night. Fields dribbles to his right, throws across to the near wing, Floyd. Floyd cross over to his left, still in the near wing, guarded by Sou. Floyd now back out to Leach. Leach over to Fields. Fields on the far wing. Fields back out, Yetna. Yetna driving into the paint. His layup is good.
How about the big man with a nice little Euro step there to get himself on the board for two?
Yetna making his third career start for the Stags. All three starts have come in the MAAC tournament. 2-2 game. Latrell Reed hands it off to Hogue. Hogue over to Marcus Randolph. Randolph now back to Latrell Reed. Latrell Reed on the far wing. Reed dribbles to the top of the key. Now working on Yetna. Step back jumper at the free throw line is good.
Nice job there by Reed to create separation. Be praised for his defense, getting it done there offensively.
Jasper Floyd over to Louis Bleachmore. Bleachmore top of the key. Now Fields. Fields over to Leach. Leach top of the key. Leach dribbles with his left, gets it poked away by So. Leach regains. He's double teamed. He's going to pass it over to Floyd on the near wing. Floyd pulls the three-pointer. It's good! Jasper Floyd gives the Stags a 5-4 lead.
Nice three there by Jasper Floyd. We saw him convert some that he was left open on. Don't leave him open if you're the Peacocks.
So 4-for-4 overall shooting to start this game. Just over 18 minutes left in the first half. Now Hogue. Back over to Reed. Latrell Reed on the far wing working on Jalen Leach. Reed dribbles to his right. He's going to reset outside. He's going to pass it to Corey Washington. The sophomore working on Fields. Washington pulls the three-pointer, and it's too strong. No good. Floyd with the board.
Nice contest there by Fields.
Jasper Floyd dribbling up the court, dribbles to his left, drives to the paint. He's going to pass it over to Yetna. Yetna back outside. Leach. Now Bleachmore. Fields. Fields is going to hold it on the near wing. He's going to pull the three now. And Caleb Fields off the front of the rim. No good.
Wanted that three from Bleachmore, but Bleachmore a little bit of an errant pass there.
Latrell Reed now. On the logo, dribbling to his right to the near wing. Hands it off to Washington. Washington out to So. So, over to Marcus Randolph. Marcus Randolph back to Latrell Reed at the top of the key. Latrell Reed guarded by Alexis Yetna. Now, going to work is Hogue. Hogue double-teamed by Yetna and Fields. Hogue picks up his dribble. He's going to shoot a three with the shot clock winding down. That's good, Michael Hogue.
Once again, better offense prevails over better defense there by Fields.
7-5, St. Peter's over Fairfield. Jalen Leach on the far wing now. Going to pass it to Louis Bleachmore. Louis Bleachmore over to Jasper Floyd. Floyd standing on the Hercules tire sign. Now to Fields. Fields has it on the logo at midcourt. He's going to pass it to Leach. Leach looking for a screen to Yetna. He's working on Washington. Leach driving into the paint with his left, spinning, up and under layup, contested, no good. Rebound pulled down by Hogue.
Tenacious defense there by the Peacocks from all four guys on that play.
Latrell Reed slowing things down for the Peacocks. Cross half court. Now to the near wing, Randolph. So, over to Washington. Washington on the far wing, guarded by Leach. Washington holding. Skip pass over to Reed. Reed guarded by Fields. Reed now driving. Pull up on the block. No good. Off the glass into the hands of Yetna. Leach now driving up the floor. Leach passes over. Floyd pumps. Dribbles. He's working his way into the paint. Fadeaway jumper in the paint. Off the left side of the rim. No good.
Right idea there by Floyd, but just couldn't convert the shot.
Latrell Reed now dribbling up the court. Pace slowing down just a tad here in the early going. 7-5. St. Peter's have the lead. 15 minutes, 15 seconds left in the first half. Muhammad So now at the top of the key. Guarded by Fields. He's going to hand it off to Latrell Reed. Reed now. Crossover move into the paint. Step back. Resetting on the near wing. Throwing inside the So now. So on the block. His hook shot no good. Gets his own rebound. Throws it off the glass. No good again. Yetna gets it this time.
Yeah, and St. Peter's is a physical team. They cannot afford to give up offensive rebounds to the Peacocks.
Jalen Leach driving into the paint. No, and there's going to be a foul. It's going to be an offensive foul. Jalen Leach is going in for the layup, and that will be a charge. And that will take us into our first officials timeout. St. Peter's has a 7-5 lead. 15 minutes, 26 seconds left in the first half. We are in store for a good one tonight, folks, here in Atlantic City. Do not go anywhere. You're listening to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM.
Trouble track. My odds are stacked. I go back.
Hello and welcome back to Atlantic City. Jim Whelan, Boardwalk Hall. The St. Peter's Peacocks have a 7-5 lead over the Fairfield Stags in the early going. Andrew, what have you seen in the first 4.5 minutes so far?
And we talked about St. Peter's scrappy nature. They're shooting really well offensively, shooting 50% from three so far, 43% from the field overall. Fairfield, on the other hand, not shooting terrible, but are in a 3-minute scoring drought as they are not able to get shots to fall as of late.
So the last bit of action that occurred just before the break was Jalen Leach had an offensive foul. That was the game's first foul. So Fairfield has one team foul. St. Peter's has none. The five on the floor for the Stags will be Jasper Floyd, Caleb Fields, Jalen Leach, Louis Bleachmore, and Alexis Yetna. The five on the floor for St. Peter's will be Marcus Randolph, Latrell Reed, Corey Washington, Michael Hogue, and Muhammad Soap. So it's the same five for each. Latrell Reed will get the inbound. It's St. Peter's ball. Fairfield in a little bit of a light press. Now up across half court is Randolph. Randolph. Hogue. Hogue working on Bleachmore. Hogue driving, going up fadeaway jumper. Good defense by Bleachmore, no good. And that will be a foul on Louis Bleachmore, who is trying to grab the rebound.
Great defense there by Bleachmore initially, just reached in there on Hogue trying to get the rebound.
So going to the line will be Corey Washington. Corey Washington, first team All-MAAC honoree. He's a sophomore. He made the All-MAAC rookie team last season. 6'6", 180 pounds, out of Sherwood, Arkansas. Stepping up to the line for his first. And he misses it. Washington on the season, coming into tonight, was an 81.5% free throw shooter.
Washington last game versus Quinnipiac was 5 of 13 with 13 points.
Washington, the leading scorer for the Peacocks, averaging over 16, nearly 17 points per game, and he misses both. Alexis Yetna grabs the rebound. It'll be Fairfield ball. Jasper Floyd dribbling up the court. Floyd, guarded by Randolph. He hands it off to Leach. Leach at the top of the key, gives it to Fields. Fields on top of the key, back to Leach. Leach on the near wing. Leach dribbled to his right, tries to get it back to Yetna, loses control, gets it back. Yetna pumps the corner three, driving inside, backing down so. Yetna now using his pivot, goes, his leg is good. The scoop with the left hand for Yetna ties the game at 7.
The St. Peter's crowd wanted to travel. Nonetheless, Yetna has two more.
We have a stoppage in play. Muhammad So upset about the non-call that Yetna had on the layup. They're looking for a travel, unless for a medical reason, maybe So got hit. So it looks like So got popped in the face here, and he's just getting a quick attention from the medical staff.
Appears he might have a bloody nose, at least from this angle.
So from the replay, he will get attention from the staff. The referees are standing in midcourt, deciding if there should be any action. I think regardless of the call, the bucket from Yetna will stand.
And I believe there is absolutely no intent behind Yetna. I think it was just an incidental bang-bang play.
Regardless what we believe, the previous play is under review. So stay right with us. We're going to take a quick break. We'll have the result of the view right after this break. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. We are at Jim Whelan Boardwalk on Atlantic City for the MAAC Men's Championship game. So we determined the cause of this review. When Alexis Yetna was driving to the basket, they're wondering if he clipped So with his elbow, and that is the review. They are still at the table now, but now that we believe we have learned what the intent of the review is, and we're about to find out now, they're having a discussion at half court. Andrew, we just had a quick break. It's 7-7, but so far, what have you seen from the Stags after having to pull off a miraculous comeback last night in their early going?
And the story of the Stags' summary here in Atlantic City so far is relatively poor shooting. They have 3 of 6 from the field so far, 1 of 2 of 3. They've kind of channeling the women's basketball team and passing up good shots for better shots. Already 2 assists on 3 field goals.
So the refs have blown the whistle. They haven't given an indication to the public address announcer about what's happening, but the scoreboard. So there's no foul on Alexis Yetna. The bucket stands. It's 7-7. 14 minutes, 41 seconds left. The same 10 players remain on the floor for each team. Fields, Floyd, Leach, Yetna, Bleachmore. And for St. Peter's, that'll be Reed, Randolph, Washington, Hogue, and So. Now on the near wing is Corey Washington. The sophomore hands over to So at the top of key. Now on the far wing, now in the far corner, Latrell Reed. Reed dribbles back out to the top. Reed working on Yetna. He's going to pull a three-pointer, and that's too short off the front of the rim. Jasper Floyd corrals the board.
Peacocks all of their last 5 from the field, 2.5-minute scoring drought.
Floyd now driving the his right on the far wing. Floyd pulls a 3, and that's good. Jasper Floyd, 2nd three-pointer of the day.
We praise Jasper Floyd for his excellent defense. How about getting it done here offensively early? 2 three-pointers.
10-7 Stags over the Peacocks. Just past the 14-minute mark of the first half. Corey Washington on the far wing, guarded by Floyd. Washington now looking for some help at the top, dribbles back to the logo at half court. Washington passes now to So. So, guarded by Yetna. So's going to drive on Yetna into the paint with the hook with the right hand, and that's money. 10-9.
So, channeling his inner Jokic there, if you will. Nice, pretty move. Separation with the finesse.
Floyd over to Bleachmore. Leach, far wing. Fields, top of key now. Fields dribbles with his left. He's double-teamed. Passes inside to a wide-open Yetna. Yetna now inside. His layup with the left hand is good. 6 points for the Fairfield big man early.
And Yetna's been huge in this game so far. Going toe-to-toe with So far. 6 points early for the big man.
Marcus Randolph now guarded by Leach. Latrell Reed guarded by Caleb Fields on the near wing. Now Muhammad So at the top of the key guarded by Yetna. So fakes the handoff and set passes to Reed. Reed driving to the basket, kicks it outside, but it'll be a foul on the floor. And that'll be a foul on Jalen Leach. That'll be his 2nd personal here in the early going. And with that being said, MAAC 6th man of the year, Bryson Goodine, checking into the game, taking a seat will be Leach. We have a substitution for the Peacocks as well. Michael Hogue will be taking a seat on the bench. Checking in will be Brent Bland, the redshirt sophomore out of Wheatley Heights, New York, for the Peacocks. Inbounding the ball for the Peacocks, Latrell Reed. Rainbow pass. Louis Bleachmore got a hand on it. It was intended for So, but it will remain Peacock ball.
Nonetheless, good contest there by Bleachmore to disrupt the play. You love to see that defensive intensity.
So we have 13 minutes, 2 seconds left, 19 seconds left on the shot clock. Randolph, the inbound, will be able to stack formation. They're immediately going to pass it in Latrell Reed. Reed now back to Randolph on the near wing. Randolph dribbles with his left. He's now going to pass it with his left hand over to Bland. Bland freshly in the game, back to Randolph. Randolph pulls the 3. Short off the front of the rim. Fields grabs the board. Moving the pace is the Stags. Floyd kicking outside. Goodine fakes the corner 3. Dribble drives his left, now outside the Yetna. They're going to reset. Floyd on the near wing now. Floyd driving with his right, going into the paint. He's going to go up with his left. And that's rejected by So. Keeping it in play is Bland. Just kidding. They're going to say Bland stepped out of bounds. This will remain Fairfield ball, but a strong rejection from the 6'9", So.
Nice ball move there by Fairfield, but given the wingspan of So, not a lot is going to get past him. Excellent block there.
So we have a substitution for the Peacocks now. Roy Clark will come on for Corey Washington. Clark, in the 2nd matchup against Fairfield, had 21 points in that game. Washington did not play. Inbounding the ball for the Stags is Floyd. Floyd is going to get it out to Caleb Fields. Fields. Crossover move, gets it back to Yetna. Yetna pulls the 3. Inside, in and out, no good. So grabs the board. The 5 on the floor for St. Peter's is Reed, So, Bland, Clark, and Randolph for the Stags. Fields, Bleachmore, Goodine, Yetna, Floyd. Back over to Marcus Randolph. In the near wing, now Latrell Reed. Latrell Reed dribbles back. Now in the corner, Marcus Randolph. Randolph driving, baseline, chaotic move off the backboard. No good with his lefty lay. But it's a loose ball and waiting for a signal on if it'll be. It'll be a jump ball. Possession arrow goes Fairfield. But with that jump ball now, we're going to take that into officials timeout. The Stags have a 12-9 lead. 11 minutes, 57 seconds left. We've had a good one in the early goings here in Atlantic City. Do not go anywhere. You're listening to Fairfield University Student Radio on 88.5 FM.
Some people search the world to find something like
Hello and welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson. Logan Runny doing a fantastic job on stats tonight. We want to collectively thank you for spending part of your Saturday evening with us. Andrew, it's a Stags 12-9 lead over St. Peter's. 11 minutes, 57 seconds left in the first half. The Stags have scored 12 points. They've had 6 from Jasper Floyd, 6 from Alexis Yetna. What have you seen from them?
And Jasper Floyd is establishing himself as an offensive playmaker here. He is efficient, 2 of 4, and he has 2 3-pointers. So he's taking advantage of the moments the St. Peacock's defense is giving him. And for Yetna, he is being that big man Fairfield desperately needs. We know this is guard you and this is a shooter's team, but Yetna has a paint presence that's been on full display so far.
Yetna had 6 points the entire game against Marist in the semis, already 6 points, and we're not even halfway through the first half. The 5 on the floor for Fairfield: Fields, Goodine, Floyd, Yetna, and Bleachmore. Goodine on the near wing. I'll detail St. Peter's 5 in a moment. Goodine's right-handed layup rattles around the rim, no good. Alexis Yetna, another offensive rebound. His putback rattles around the rim and falls home. 14-9 Stags.
Now you're seeing what Yetna is capable of. This is the Yetna we've been waiting for in Stag country.
The 5 on the floor for St. Peter's: Reed, Randolph, Hogue, Bland, Clark. Actually, excuse me, that's Clark, not Randolph. And so, those are the 5 on the floor for St. Peter's. Reed in the far corner, guarded by Fields. Reed gets double-teamed. He's going to pass up out. Roy Clark, deep 3, no good. But so grabs the offensive rebound, and with the left hand off the glass, puts it in.
That ends nearly a 2.5-minute scoring drought. St. Peter's just 2 of their last 10 from the field.
14-11 the score. Goodine passes out the Fields. Fields standing on the logo now. Fields, crossover move, drives in, looks to shoot, and says he's going to pass it outside the Goodine. Goodine now driving, out to Bleachmore. Bleachmore, deep 3, no good.
Not sure if I love that shot there from Bleachmore, testing his luck a little bit.
Rebound hauled in by Brent Bland, who gives it to Reed. Reed worked over by Fields, who's going to give it over to Roy Clark. Clark guarded by Bleachmore. Now Hogue immediately gives it over to Bland, back over to So on the far wing. So finds Reed, guarded by Fields. Reed in the far corner. He's backing down Fields. He's double-teamed by Floyd. Gets it inside the Hogue. Hogue's fadeaway, bank shot, no good. Yetna with the board.
Beautiful defense there by Bleachmore.
Fairfield moving in transition. Jasper Floyd now. Floyd fakes the handoff to Fields. Now gives it to him as a regular pass. Goodine on the near wing. Goodine dribbles with his left. Passes to Yetna. Yetna outside Floyd. Fields, far wing now. Dribbles his left. Inside, Bleachmore. Bleachmore goes up with a layup. It's good. Bleachmore strong with the defense in his face.
Bleachmore not shying away from the mismatch there on So. 5-point lead for the Stags.
So after the Bleachmore layup, 16-11 is the score. 9 minutes, 45 seconds and rolling here in the first half. Hogue, guarded by Bleachmore. Over to Roy Clark. Clark guarded by sixth man of the year, Bryson Goodine. Clark dribbles to the top of the key, switches to Bleachmore. Now Brent Bland. Bland guarded by Floyd. Inside now, double-teamed is Hogue, and Fields is going to rip the ball away.
Cookies, Ryan, cookies.
Caleb Fields up the court. Louis Bleachmore back to Fields. Fields for the 3. It's good! Caleb Fields for 3, and that'll be a St. Peter's timeout.
Picking up right where he left off. Caleb Fields with 22 in the last game. Clutch steal, takes it to the other end of the court. Bang!
19-11, Stags over the Peacocks. 9 minutes, 20 seconds left. Head coach Bashir Mason has taken his first timeout, and so are we. Don't go anywhere. We have a good one, folks, on Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM.
Thoughts to pass before you know it, you're frozen. But something happened for the very first time with you. My heart melted to the ground. Something true, and everyone's looking round, thinking I'm going crazy.
Welcome back to Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, Atlantic City. You're listening to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jameson. We've had a substitution for the Peacocks. On the floor, Brent Bland, Roy Clark, Latrell Reed, Corey Washington, and Muhammad So. For the Stags, it remains Fields, Goodine, Bleachmore, Floyd, and Yetna. Holding the ball is Washington, now passing up to Reed. Reed dribbling on the MAAC and Women's Bench Basketball Championship logo. He gets poked away by Goodheim. Reed now spinning and has to give it up to So. Over to Bland. Wing three from Clark. It's good.
Much needed there by St. Peter's coming out of that media timeout to cut into the Stags' lead.
Good passing from the St. Peter's to open up an open shot for Clark. Goodheim responds with a three of his own. That's good. One of the best three-point shooters in the nation is on the board.
Anything you can do, I can do better. Goodheim answers.
22-14 is the score. Fairfield over St. Peter's. Reed guarded by Fields as he passes half court. Reed, now So, on the near wing, is going to give it over to Bland. Bland, now Roy Clark on the far wing. Clark back to Bland. Bland picks up his dribble, gets it to So on the top of the key. Now Reed on the near wing. Reed, guarded by Fields. So, in the corner, pumps, drives, his layup, no good. Rebound falls into the hands of Alexis Yetna.
Great
moving
composure
up the court
there.
With pace is Fields. Fields, on the near wing. Backing down. And that'll be a foul on Latrell Reed, the MAAC Defensive Player of the Year. Checking into the game, freshman Peyton Smith. Subbing out of the game, Alexis Yetna, who has given the Stags very impactful minutes thus far.
Yes, he has 8 points for the big man, already exceeding his total in that last game versus Marist.
Yetna exits the game to a standing ovation from the Fairfield faithful. Smith last game had 9 very impactful points off the bench. Floyd the inbounder, who immediately gives it to Smith, who gets it out to Goodheim. Goodheim near the top of the key. Caleb Fields into the wing. Pass inside to Smith. Smith rejected. He gets his own rebound. Passes outside, but his pass outside is tipped. That was tipped by Brent Bland. So it'll be Fairfield ball. 14 seconds left on the shot clock. 7 minutes, 54 seconds left. But before Fairfield inbounds the ball again, we have another official's timeout. So, folks, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jameson, Logan Rundy on Sats. We want to thank you for spending part of your Saturday evening listening to us call this fantastic game between the Fairfield Stags and the St. Peter's Peacocks. Andrew, Fairfield is a 22-14 lead with 7 minutes and 54 seconds left in the first half. This has been a phenomenal start for Fairfield.
It has been, and they're spreading the love. 6 assists already. Fairfield had 8 in that entire game versus Marist, and the Stags are hitting on their shots. They are quality and quantity. 9 of 17 from the field overall, 57% from 3. This is the Stags this Fairfield faithful has rallied behind, and this is the brand of basketball Fairfield loves to play.
And we mentioned how they struggled from 3-point shot, especially in the last two games drastically. What also makes the start so impressive is first-team All-MAC honoree and Fairfield's leading scorer, Jalen Leach, got in foul trouble early and has mostly not played so far.
And when your best player and leading scorer is not on the court and your other guys are thriving, the whole team feeds off of that, and that not only creates chemistry, but everyone is going to be firing and want to contribute. A great camaraderie right now for the Stags.
So the 5 on the floor for the Stags with Peyton Smith, who just recently checked into the game before the officials' timeout.
A few Fairfield officials here tonight as Coach Dodonis and Mark Nemec are courtside, along with most of our athletics department here at Fairfield University.
Louis Bleachmore, Bryson Goodheim, Jasper Floyd, and Caleb Fields round out the other 4. And on the court right now, we have Stephon Roberts checking into the game for the first time. Brent Bland, Roy Clark, Latrell Reed, and Corey Washington. Caleb Fields across half court. Fields, under 10 seconds left on the shot clock. He goes up with a scoop with his left hand. That's no good. The rebound's poked free, and that's going to be a foul on Fairfield.
Yeah, good. That
will go on Peyton
after.
Smith, the foul.
Fairfield call number 33, Peyton Smith. That's his first personal.
That'll be his first personal. That is Fairfield's fourth team foul of the half.
Like the aggression there from Smith, just got to be a little bit more careful when the reaching.
The freshman Smith started every single game before getting hurt against Iona later in the season in the first minute, and since then, with other players coming back from injury, has not seen the same minutes he used to. Dribbling ball now, Latrell Reed. Reed guarded on the far wing by Goodine. Reed now circles back around, passes over to Brent Bland. Brent Bland on the near wing. Sends it back to Reed. Reed driving with his left. He's going baseline. He's going to send it back out. Roy Clark now. Crossover dribble, skip pass. The three-pointer from Washington as the shot clock expires, no good. But St. Peter's got the offensive board. Reed now. Reed's going to reset things. Clark. Clark at the top of the key. Clark driving on Peyton Smith. It's poked away by Goodine into the hands of Brent Bland. Bland now over to Reed. Shot clock at five. Reed for three. It's good. Lachelle Reed, 22-17, Stags over St. Peter's.
Gave Reed just a little bit too much breathing room there, the Stags defense.
Floyd over to Bleachmore. Fields. Fields. Goodine top of the key. Goodine dribbles at his right. Goodine passes inside to Floyd. It's a loose ball. Still loose. That's going to be a foul. That'll be a foul, I believe, on Brent Bland, waiting for the official signal. It will be. So Brent Bland will pick up his first personal. It'll be the second foul for St. Peter's.
St. Peter's done a good job for the most part in this first half, staying out of foul trouble. Only two team fouls. That's huge when you're not allowing your opponent any way to get back into the game with extra free throws.
Checking into the game, James Johns Jr. in for Louis Bleachmore. Johns Jr. in the second matchup against St. Peter's this season went for double digits in the victory. Fields got the inbound. Fields backing into the paint. His fadeaway jumper off the front rim, in and out. Peyton Smith tries to corral the board, but it was loose. It bounced off of Latrell Reed and out of bounds. So it will remain Fairfield ball, and they'll get 20 seconds on the shot clock. 6 minutes, 29 seconds left here in the first half. Fairfield has a five-point lead, 22-17.
Encouraging sign there for Peyton Smith.
Inbound to the Smith. Smith deep two, no good, too strong. Brent Bland had the board. He's going to give it over to Latrell Reed. Reed now. He'll be picked up by Floyd. Floyd set the single season record for steals by a Fairfield player in a season. He has 79 steals on the season. Pulling up on the far wing jumper, the bank is open for Latrell Reed.
Yeah,
five consecutive points for the senior.
Latrell Reed leading the Peacocks, putting them on his back right now.
Floyd over to Johns Jr. Caleb Fields now, top of the key. Over to Floyd, 22-19 is the score. Floyd driving. Spinning on his pivot foot, passes Smith. Smith layup rejected from behind by Roberts. Moving with pace to St. Peter's. Washington now. Washington going in. Baseline, uncontrolled shot, no good. Roberts tries to save it from going out of bounds to no avail. It will be Fairfield ball, 22-19.
Yeah, Stags a little bit of a drought here. No points in the last 3 minutes and 0 from their last five from the field. So got to get back to the fundamentals and better passing.
That was Stefan Roberts with the rejection. Latrell Reed checking out of the game, coming into the game for the first time. Freshman Armani Ziegler, the 6'4", 185-pound freshman out of Emmyville, New York. James Johns Jr. now with the ball. He gives it back to Floyd. Floyd dribbles across half court, anticipating a double team he did not get. Johns Jr. over to Fields. Fields Goodine top of the key now. Goodine crossover. Pulls the three. Bryce Goodine too strong. Peyton Smith fights for the rebound. It falls into the hands of Johns Jr. Johns Jr. goes up for the after getting the rebound, and he's fouled on the way back up.
Great
so
job,
Johns Jr. will shoot two.
Great job by Johns Jr. staying with the play, not giving up, going to the line for two. As a result, fifth offensive rebound for the Stags here.
That foul was committed by senior Stefan Roberts, the 6'10", 230-pound Brooklyn, New York native. James Johns Jr. now will step to the line. He's seen limited action thus far in these games. He's not taken a free throw yet today. Johns Jr., a 6'6", 200-pound sophomore out of Claymont, Delaware, nails the first of two. James Johns Jr. only shoots 51.6% from the free throw line coming into today. Looking to go two for two and extend the Fairfield lead back up to five. Johns Jr. The second one rims around, hits the backboard and falls. 24-19 is the score. Fairfield in a little bit of a light press. Now they're sending two up on Roy Clark. Roy Clark sends it over to Brent Brand.
Dangerous pass there.
Bland gets it back to Clark. Now Washington. Washington back to Clark. Clark dribbles to the far wing. He's guarded by Floyd. He's going to get a screen from Roberts, now guarded by Smith. Clark driving it with the paint, and that's going to be an offensive foul. Roy Clark hit him with the Heisman to Peyton Smith. Smith drawing the offensive foul. That'll be Fairfield ball.
Good composure there by Peyton Smith. You're seeing the maturity of this freshman get better in this tournament as he is becoming a more well-rounded player.
We're now seeing St. Peter start defending in the front court, and Jasper Floyd is going to draw the foul on Roy Clark. So just like that, St. Peter's is up to 15 fouls, and that is Roy Clark's second personal foul. So with that, Clark checking out of the game, coming into the game, Latrell Reed.
And Roy Clark had 19 in that second game Fairfield and St. Peter's played. He is a key piece.
Floyd now, over to James John Jr. Goodine, back to Fields. Fields, crossover move, top of the key. Goodine thought about stepping into three, instead driving after pump faking. Fade away, jump shot from Goodine, he's fouled. That'll be Stefan Roberts on the foul. That'll be Roberts' second personal. That'll be St. Peter's sixth. And that's going to send Fairfield one foul away from being into the bonus.
I feel like I into existence when I praised St. Peter's for foul trouble. They've committed four fouls in the last 3 minutes here. As a result, Bryson Goodine going to the line for two. Fairfield one foul away from the bonus.
We mentioned earlier Bryson Goodine, one of the most prolific three-point shooters in the nation, shoots 76.2% from the free throw line. He misses the first of two too strong off the backboard. Goodine has had an interesting road. Last season, he only played four games for the Stags before suffering a season-ending injury. But before coming to Fairfield, Bryson Goodine spent time under Ed Cooley at Providence. And before that, he was initially with Syracuse before transferring to Providence. As Goodine nails a second of two to make it a 25-19 game. This has been Goodine's first truly healthy season in his career for the redshirt senior, and he's been absolutely productive, one of the best three-point shooters in the nation. Latrell Reed pressed. He turns it over to James John Jr., who's blocked from behind, but that's a foul.
That's an ugly
Brent
landing.
Bland, and James John Jr. smacked his head hard into the base of the basket. He's getting up and appears to be okay.
Phenomenal defense there, though, by the Stags.
So that'll be Brent Bland's personal foul, and for whatever reason, the past minute or so, St. Peter's cannot stop fouling. So James Johns Jr. will shoot at the line. He just went 2 of 2, as we mentioned earlier, 51.6%. But going back to Goodine, Goodine started his career at Syracuse, where coming out of high school, he was a top 100-ranked prospect nationally by ESPN.com, 24/7 Sports. As you see, James John Jr. just missed his first free throw. Checking into the game for St. Peter's will be Michael Hogue. Checking out of the game will be Brent Bland, who just picked up his second personal. And Goodine has really thrived. As I mentioned earlier, he was named sixth man of the year for the MAAC and also a third all-team MAAC honoree and has been an irreplaceable cog in the machine that is the Stags offense. John's Jr.'s second free throw is good. The Stags have a 26-19 lead. They're up 7 with 4 minutes 27 seconds left. Inbounding the ball is Ziegler. Ziegler gets over to Washington. Now Reed. Reed pressed by Fields. They had one turnover in the front court that led to those James Johns Jr. free throws. Reed now calling for help. Doesn't get it. Picks up his dribble. Now over to Washington. Washington on the near wing, guarded by James Johns Jr. Washington into the baseline. Now Reed. Reed has it. He backs into the corner. He goes crossover move on Smith. He's under the basket, can't get rid of it. Caleb Fields pokes it away. Fields off to the races. He's with Jasper Floyd. Fields goes up with a layup, and he's fouled. Armani Ziegler, the freshman, committing the foul. And that will take us into an official's timeout. So St. Peter's putting about every single player they have into the foul sheet. Fairfield taking advantage. 26-19, the Stags lead over the Peacocks. First half coming to a close soon. Do not go anywhere. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jameson. And you are listening to Fairfield University Student Radio on 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson. Once again, I want to thank you for spending part of your Saturday evening with us. We know at Fairfield University today was the Sham Jam festivities, and they saw the Fairfield's women's team back on campus secure their ticket into the dance. And now the Stags, the men's, 26-19, they hold the lead, and they also looking to punch their ticket back to the big dance for the first time since 1997.
And how have they created a little bit of separation? St. Peter's has not stopped fouling. A little bit ago, we praised them for just at two team fouls with just about 6 minutes to go. All of a sudden, they're at eight team fouls. Fairfield in the bonus and has made the most of their opportunities for the most part from the line. 4 of 6, Fairfield will gladly take those extra points, Ryan.
So when we come back, it'll be Caleb Fields shooting free throws. And as we mentioned, St. Peter's has been fouling nonstop, and this is where you have to take advantage. Because, you know, at one point or another, it's going to be a very close game. And in championship games, your margin for error is about as thin gets. And you have to be able to make your free throws. Stepping up to the line, Caleb Fields, who has been absolutely money. He scored 20 points in the quarters against Iona. He scored 22 in the semis against Marist. Now he takes a 74.2% free throw percentage into this trip to the Fairfield line now. The Stags as a team, 4 for 6 from the line tonight. Field shooting two. Makes the first. Fields is on the court with Floyd Goodine, Peyton Smith, and James John Jr. And for St. Peter's, it'll be Michael Hogue, Corey Washington, Muhammad So, Marcus Randolph, and Latrell Reed. Fields looking for his second. No good. Rebound to the hands of Hogue. The score is 27-19 Fairfield. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left here in the first half. Goodine forces the steal on Reed. Goodine goes up with a layup, no good. Fields, the putback is good. The press forces a turnover, and the Stags get a quick two, 29-19. And they force another turnover. And this time it'll be a foul on Fields. Fields almost jumped the route, and instead it was corralled by Washington, and he'll draw the foul on Fields.
But you're seeing how deadly this press is when Chris Casey turns the intensity up defensively. This Stags team is a force.
The Stags right now are absolutely hounding the Peacocks, and they're having a miserable time trying to get the ball up court. Latrell Reed now working on Goodine. He's doubled by Floyd and Goodine. Latrell Reed down to the baseline is So. So in the near corner. Back out to Reed. Reed settling things down. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Reed standing on the logo. Guarded by Goodine at the top of the key. Calling for somebody, anybody. Peyton Smith nearly jumps that pass and said it's So. So's pass tipped. It was intended for Washington in the corner. Jasper Floyd got his fingers on it. So there'll be 4 seconds left on the shot clock when St. Peter's inbounds this ball.
Stags absolutely hounding the Peacocks right now. It's resulted in a 7-0 run in nearly 2 minutes. 4 turnovers for the Peacocks in the last 2.5 minutes. No score, no points since.
3 minutes, 11 seconds left. 29-19 Fairfield over St. Peter's. Inbounding the ball is Reed. 4 seconds left on the shot clock. Reed gets it outside. So passes to Randolph. Randolph's three. No good. Offensive rebound, Hogue. Hogue, was it foul on the floor or foul on the way up? It'll be a foul, I believe, on the floor. It'll go on James Johns Jr. Yes, it was confirmed on the floor. So that'll be James Johns Jr., his first personal. That'll be the 6th team foul for the Stags. Inbounding the ball will be Latrell Reed. The senior throws a rainbow pass out to Hogue. Hogue in the paint. Guarded by Floyd. Hogue goes up, goes strong with good defense. He gets the layup, 29-21.
Much needed there for the Peacocks.
Floyd, James Johns Jr. over to Fields on the near wing. Fields, bounce pass to Goodine at the top of the key. Goodine gets a screen from Peyton Smith. Goodine goes around So. Goodine hard to the rack, and that's rejected by So. It'll remain Fairfield ball.
That's 2 emphatic blocks now on So. He is doing everything he can defensively to keep the Stags cool.
Peyton Smith checks out of the game to an ovation from the Fairfield faithful. Checking back into the game will be Alexis Yetna. Inbounding the ball, Jasper Floyd. Floyd bounce pass into Yetna, immediately at the Goodine. Goodine dribbles to the top of the key. Now Fields on the far wing. Fields gets a pick from Yetna. Fields looking on the far wing, picks up his dribble. Now Yetna. Yetna hands it back to Fields. Fields dribbles to the left inside. Fields goes up with the right off the glass. No good, too strong.
Errant shot there. Not the best decision by Fields.
Latrell Reed pushing up the pace. Latrell Reed hard into the rack. His layup with the right. No good. That was as easy gets, and he missed it. The St. Peter's got the offensive board. Their second attempt blocked. Their third attempt good.
That's that scrappy nature of St. Peter's. They just don't give up.
Corey Washington with the two. 29-23 the score now. The lead cut to six. James John Jr., sloppy handoff. Goodine gets the loose ball. Goodine at the top of the key. Just about to pass the two-minute mark in the first half. Goodine pulls the three. Off, way off. Long rebound out to Reed. Reed pushing the pace in transition. Going up is Marcus Randolph. He's fouled on the play. And going to the line, shooting two will be Marcus Randolph. That foul will be on Bryson Goodine.
Fairfield struggling from the court offensively as of late. Just one of their last 11. St. Peter's on a mini run here, 4-0.
So checking into the game for Stags after one free throw will be Louis Bleachmore. Randolph going to the line for two. The junior, 6'5", 205 pounds out of Willingboro, New Jersey. He steps up to the line shooting an exact 69% from the charity stripe coming into tonight. St. Peter's 0-for-2 on their only free throws tonight so far. Now make it 1-for-3. The score, 29-24. Checking out of the game, James Johns Jr., giving his most productive minutes in the tournament in his most recent stint. Coming out of the game for St. Peter's is Michael Hogue. Checking into the game will be freshman Armani Ziegler. So Bleachmore, Ziegler in, Johns Jr., Hogue out. Randolph shooting his second. It's good. 29-25 is the score. Both teams in the bonus. Minute 50 seconds left here in the first half. Bleachmore now gets it back to Fields. Quick pass up to Goodine. Goodine over to Fields. Fields top of the key. He's guarded by Washington. Bleachmore now. Floyd back to Fields. Fields guarded by Washington. Fields driving on Washington. His layup contested, no good. Yet at the offensive board. He gets it out. Bleachmore pumps. Bleachmore now drives. His layup no good, but there's going to be a foul on the play.
St. Peter's has pissed that crowd and that bench.
St. Peter's has a large contingency here at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, and they're very displeased with the foul on Armani Ziegler. But that play was kept alive by Alexis Yetna, and Louis Bleachmore goes in, clipped on the way in by Ziegler. The Peacock faithful vociferating, booing the referees. Louis Bleachmore, the 6'6 native out of Sydney, Australia, the senior, misses the first.
Fairfield from the line today, 5 of 9 now. St. Peter's just 2 of 4.
The St. Peter's crowd erupts. Bleachmore came into that trip to the line 60% on the year. The Stags only shooting 5 of 9 from the stripe. Bleachmore's second free throw is good. 30-25 is the score now. Latrell Reed now. Dribbling up the court, guarded by Fields. Minute 25 seconds left in the first half. Reed, guarded by Fields. Reed calling for somebody, not getting it. Instead, he's going to drive to his right on Fields. He's going to spin back around to the near wing. Now he gets to the So. So, Ziegler now. Ziegler, top of the key. Ziegler drives, goes in. It'll be a foul on the floor on Bryson Goodine. That'll be Goodine's second foul, Fairfield's 18th foul. So the Peacocks will be shooting free throws here. Armani Ziegler, the freshman, shooting 63.3% from the line. Now, checking into the game for Fairfield, Matt Curtis, the freshman making his first appearance of the tournament. Curtis, 6'4", 190 pounds, out of Ellington, Connecticut. So Ziegler now shooting a 1-1. He misses the first. Floyd corrals the board. Floyd now. Jalen Leach has not appeared in this game since getting two early fouls. Hence why you're seeing Matt Curtis making his tournament debut with a minute left in the first half here in the championship. Caleb Fields dribbling at the top of the key. Shot clock nearing 10. Fields driving. Fadeaway. Jump shot. Too strong off the back of the rim. And that was a little bit of a same team situation for St. Peter's. They tip it off of each other out of bounds.
Yeah, and it's those little plays, Ryan, that can really shift the momentum. Not that Fairfield doesn't have it already, but those are one. That's one St. Peter's is going to want back for sure.
Fairfield, no field goals in nearly the last 3 minutes. They're 0 for their last 5 and 1 for their last 13. Floyd inbounds to Yetna. Over to Fields. Fields now working inside. Fields working on Reed. A fadeaway again off the backboard. No good. Yetna, first putback, no good. Second putback, yes, sir.
And Yetna has been consistent all night. 5 of 6 from the field now with 10 points.
32-25. There's about a half a second difference between the shot and game clock. Just about over 20 seconds left here in the first half. dribbling the ball, sitting on it is Reed. It looks like St. Peter's is going to try and wait for the last shot. Reed dribbles to his right, hands off to Randolph. Randolph over to Ziegler. Reed now in the near wing. Ziegler driving baseline after getting the pass. And that is going to be a charge. Alexis Yetna will jar the charge on the freshman.
We're not even half in. I think this is his best game of the season already. Alexis Yetna is doing it on both ends of the court.
So with 7.2 seconds left, Chris Casey is going to take his first time out of the game and draw up a play for the end of the half here. We're going to take a quick break on this 30-second timeout. Don't go anywhere. We have 7.2 seconds left in the half. Fairfield 32, St. Peter's 25. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jameson. You are listening to 88.5 FM. The Fairfield Stags up 32, St. Peter's 25. Alexis Yetna just drew a charge on the freshman Armani Ziegler. Yetna's been the story of the first half, but we'll get to him in a moment. 7.2 seconds left. Caleb Fields the inbounder. Coach Casey just took a timeout to draw up this play on the floor for the Stags. Freshman Matt Curtis, Jasper Floyd, Alexis Yetna, and Louis Bleachmore. The five for the Peacocks. Reed, Bland, Randolph, So, and Washington. Fields racing up the court. Fields, under 3 seconds to go. Yetna, the three! Short, no good. So this half will conclude. Fairfield up 32. St. Peter's 25. We are one half through at Joe Whelan Boardwalk Hall, Atlantic City. Andrew, real quick, what is your instant reaction to the first half?
Fairfield's been the aggressors here. They're winning the battle of the boards. They are forcing turnovers at a higher rate than St. Peter's is. Fairfield only has one turnover on the game, so ball security has been phenomenal, to say the least, although I don't want to jinx it. But 11 offensive rebounds really goes to show the tenacity and physicality this team has put on display thus far.
Well, we want to thank you for spending part of your Saturday evening listening to us here at WVOF, Fairfield University Student Radio. We will be back shortly. Folks, we have a good one. Fairfield 32, St. Peter's 25. We are 20 minutes away from finding out who will be punching their ticket into the NCAA March Madness Tournament. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back soon.
Questioning, where is the love? Where is the love? Where is the love? dropping bombs. Chemical gases filling lungs of little ones with ongoing suffering as the youth are young. So ask yourself, is the loving really gone? So I could ask myself, really, what is going wrong in this world that we living in? People keep on giving in, making wrong decisions, only visions of them dividends. Not respecting each other, denying thy brother. A war's going on, but the reason's undercover. The truth is kept secret, it's swept under the rug. If you never know truth, then you never know love. What's the love, y'all? Come on. Where's the truth, y'all? Come on,
I don't know.
Oh, where's the love, y'all?
We're killing people, dying, children hurting, and crying. When you practice what you preach, and what you turn the other cheek. Father, 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 help us. Need some guidance from above. These people got me questioning. Where is the love?
Where is the love?
The world on my shoulder. As I'm getting older, your people get colder. Most of us only care about money making. Selfishness got us following the wrong direction. Wrong information always shown by the media. Negative images is the main criteria. Infecting the young minds faster than bacteria. Kids wanna act like what they see in the cinema. Yeah. Whatever happened to the values of humanity? Whatever happened to the fairness and equality? Instead of spreading love, we're spreading animosity. Lack of understanding leading us away from unity. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling under. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling down. It's no wonder why sometimes I'm feeling under. Gotta keep my faith alive till love is found. Now ask yourself,
where is the love? Where is the love? Where is the love? One word, one word.
We only got
one word, one word.
That's all we got.
One word, one word.
And something's wrong with it. Yeah. Something's wrong with it.
Yeah.
Something's wrong with the good world, world. Yeah. We only got
one word, one word.
That's all we got.
One word.
What it do, baby boy?
Yeah, lil' mama, you looking good. I see you on the plate with a player from the hood. Come holler at me, you got it like that. Big Snoop Dogg with the lead pussycat. I show you how I go that. Yeah, I wanna throw that. Me and you, one-on-one, treat it like a show that. You look at me and I look at you. I'm reaching for your shirt, what you want me to do?
I'm telling you to loosen up my buttons, baby. But you keep running. Say what you gon' do to me. You gon' do to me, but I ain't seen nothing.
Typical and hardly the type of bubble. I like when the physical don't leave me asking for more. I'm a sexy mama, just how to get what I wanna. All I do is string this on ya. Of all the things that I told ya.
what you want, but I need what I need. Now let me tell you what's crackin' like before I proceed. I'ma show you where to put it at. PCD on me, yeah, I thought I saw a pussycat. Now roll with the big dog, all six of y'all on me. Now tell me how I feel, baby doll. Ashley, Nicole, Carmi, Jessica, Kimberly, Melody, you telling me?
Hot. Listen up. Yeah. I can't take this.
Hello and welcome back, where I am Ryan Canfield and Andrew Jameson, and you are listening to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. We are coming to you live from Atlantic City Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, where the Fairfield Stags have raced out to a 32-25 lead in the MAAC Men's Championship game. Andrew, there's been a couple of main storylines in the first half, but none bigger than Alexis Yetna.
And this is the Yetna the Stags have been waiting for all season. A dominant paint presence who can also facilitate and rebound at a high level. Not only does he have 10 points on 5 of 8 shooting, he has 8 rebounds, 4 of them offensive, which has been huge in second chance points.
And let's do a little bit of a deep dive into Alexis Yetna. So he didn't make his Fairfield debut until earlier in the season. And his last active campaign was the 2021-2022 season, where he was with Seton Hall. Yetna appeared in 31 games that season with 72-17 starts at Seton Hall. The 6'8 forward, he was 7th in the Big East with a team best 7.6 rebounds per contest to go along with 8.1 points per outing. He recorded 8 double-doubles that season while helping guide the Pirates to 21 wins and get an at-large bid in the NCAA tournament. Now, Yetna, a native of Paris, France, did not begin his career at Seton Hall. He began his career at USFF, at USF. Yetna was tabbed as the AAC Freshman of the Year in 2019 after averaging 12.3 points per game and 9.6 rebounds per game with 15 doubles. So Alexis Yetna, this is the best we have seen in a Fairfield Stags uniform, but he's not unfamiliar to playing like this.
Absolutely, and you know, Seton Hall Division I experience always helps, but what is most important, he's healthy. Health dictates success in a way. We see Jalen Leach is fully healthy for the first time in career. What did he have? He had a phenomenal season and was first team All-MAC. So the Stags are finally healthy and this roster is looking to make some noise.
This is the best we've seen Alexis Yetna, and this is the Alexis Yetna that Fairfield, as you mentioned, has been waiting for, and he's been forced to really carry the load tonight because Jalen Leach, All-MAC first team honoree for the Fairfield Stags, picked up 2 quick ones and rode the bench for the rest of the first half.
I'm not going to count Jalen Leach out just yet. We saw a similar story in that game against Damaris where he had 0 points in that first half and bounced back in a big way when Fairfield needed him most for 13 in the second half. I expect a similar story. I think he is a mature enough player to know what he needs to do to contribute to the team's success and punch their ticket to the dance.
So let's take a peek at the numbers here for Fairfield. They're shooting 33.3% from the field, 11 from 33 overall. They made 4 of 10 from deep, and they made 6 of 10 of the free throw line. They have 22 rebounds. They're out-rebounding St. Peter's 22-18. And as Andrew mentioned earlier, they have 6 assists, which matched their total from last game. St. Peter's only with 3 assists in the early going.
And the other eye-popping stat that you missed, 1 turnover by the Stags. 1. Just goes to show
for St. Peter's.
The ball security is at an elite level right now, and Casey has to be thrilled, but not satisfied quite yet. He wants that number to stay at one.
So on the flip side, St. Peter's shooting 10 of 26, 38.5%. They are 3 of 9 from deep and a paltry 2 of 5 from the free throw line. Leading the Peacocks in scoring, Latrell Reed has 7, Muhammad So with 5, and Brent Bland with a pair. Actually, excuse me, Reed leads the team in scoring with 7. So leads the team in rebounds with 5. Bland has 2 of 3 Peacock assists.
And another reason why Fairfield's out to this lead, free throws. I know I sound like a broken record, but St. Peter's could not stop fouling within the last 5 minutes of that first half. As a result, Fairfield converted from their opportunities at the free throw line, although their statistics from there aren't exactly indicative of that as we look at that. 40% the Peacocks are from the charity strike, 2 of 5 that is. Fairfield, conversely, 6 of 10, good for a 60% clip. So the sample size does favor Fairfield and can be considered a reason why Fairfield is out in front here.
So now that we've recapped the first half, Andrew, what are you looking for the second half from St. Peter's to try and claw back in this one down 7?
I think St. Peter's, it comes down to a matter of offense. Corey Washington is a first-team All-MAC selection. He was held to 4 points in that first half. 2 of 6 from the field, 0 of 2 from 3. And Latrell Reed, who is your defensive player of the year in the MAC, is leading the Peacocks in scoring with 7. St. Peter's needs a more well-rounded effort if they want to claw back into this game.
The Stags, they're up 7, 20 minutes away from their first NCAA tournament berth since 1997. What do they need to do to get this across the finish line?
Ball security, number one. I'll keep that short and sweet. They have done a great job so far. That needs to stay there given St. Peter's scrappy defense. And we saw them bend but not break against both Quinnipiac and Ryder. They need to do the same and make sure St. Peter's doesn't get back into this game. Also for Fairfield, pass up good shots for better shots. At this point, I feel like it's a matter of quality over quantity. You have a lead. Now you have to build on it. Don't do anything unnecessary. Just play your brand of basketball, the smash mouth defense, the high flying and prolific offense, and the Stags are hoping to be in their first dance since 1997.
Breaking down the huddle for Fairfield, captain guard Caleb Fields. We are just about underway in the second half here, folks. We've had a very entertaining first half. We have a absolutely raucous crowd here at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, who have been phenomenal hosts to us all week long. We've been here every day watching multiple games. And Andrew, we are Fairfield winning this game from having the perfect week. The women winning the championship and the men winning the championship.
And that's the hope, Brian. However, the job is far from finished. We cannot get ahead of ourselves. We have to keep focus at the task at hand, which is finish this game strong. Off to a good start here as the first half displays as the Stags are up 7.
So as I mentioned earlier, the Stags beat the Peacocks in the season series 2-0 in the season series. When the Stags play someone that they have previously swept in the season, in the postseason, they are 12-7 on those 19 occasions.
And the Stags, one of the things they do great is bounce back. They learn from their mistakes. They're a complete team who absorbs information and uses it and improves upon it. This is the identity of the team the whole season. Chris Casey has been the epitome of a leader, and the team is building off of it and showing it in full force.
We mentioned earlier, this is also St. Peter's third game in 3 nights, where Fairfield had a day off, multiple days off before their first game, day off, game, and now this is their first back-to-back. Whereas, as we said, St. Peter's never even had a back-to-back earlier in the year, let alone a back-to-back-to-back. Do you expect maybe some tired legs in the second half?
I think there's absolutely going to be tired legs in the second half. Every game, as you go on in this tournament, gets more grueling, more physical, more demanding. And tonight has been no exception. You're seeing guys fatigue left and right. So it goes to show the commitment and the passion these basketball players have and their desire to win.
Well, here we go. The Stags sending out their same starting five. Floyd, Fields, Leach, Bleachmore, and Yetna. St. Peter's will start with the ball, and they will send out Marcus Randolph, Latrell Reed, Corey Washington, Roy Clark, instead of Michael Hogue, and Muhammad So. And we are off. The second half here in Atlantic City. Now going on, Clark. Washington at the top of the key. Passes it over to Randolph. So, driving into the paint hard, it'll be a foul on the floor That'll be on Louis Bleachmore, blocking foul, his second personal, Fairfield's first team foul, just 13 seconds in to the second half.
Yeah, and St. Peter's has started each second half of their games aggressive and physical. St. Peter's is going to be that the same. Fairfield has to meet their physicality.
Inbounding the ball, Latrell Reed. He's going to throw a jump pass for Washington, who's going to be fouled on the shot attempt. That'll be Jasper Floyd on the shooting foul.
Two fouls and not even 15 seconds. Definitely not an ideal start to the second half for Casey's squad.
Not at all. Washington 0 for 2 today on the shooting free throws. Coming in today, the leading scorer for the Peacocks shoots 81.5% on the season. Washington, first team All-MAAC honoree, makes his first free throw. So the score is now 32 to 26 Stags. 6'6", sophomore lining up a second. And it's good, so he makes two of two. 32-27 the score. Jasper Floyd now up the court. Meeting him will be Marcus Randolph. Floyd over to Fields. Now Leach at the top of the key. Leach, his first time in the game after leaving early in the first half for two quick fouls. Floyd now on the far wing. Floyd dribbles in, centers back out to the top of the key. Passes to Leach. Leach on the near wing. Leach goes to his left, dribbles to the top of the key. Leach, dribble drives inside the paint on So, pumps. His layup is good, and that's the Jalen Leach we know.
Beautiful fake there to get So to jump. That's the Jalen Leach's bread and butter. Get into the paint, easy two.
34-27 now. Latrell Reed dribbling up the court. Guarded by Fields. Reed passes it over to Roy Clark. Clark out to Washington. Washington finds Randolph, who immediately gives it to So. So guarded by Leach. Now he gives it to Marcus Randolph on the wing. Randolph into the corner. Corey Washington guarded by Bleachmore. Washington now. Shot clock at three. Washington spinning. Fadeaway jumper off the front of the rim. Rebound. Loose ball. Goes into the hands of Roy Clark. New shot clock for the Peacocks.
Much needed there for the Peacocks. Another life.
Clark dribbling with his right hand, driving on Yetna. His layup is good. Drove in on Alexis Yetna, went in with the right, finished with the left. Bleachmore now over to Leach. Leach, Fields, top of the key. Fields dribbled to his right. Fields driving, is going to kick it back outside. Bleachmore, three, top of the key. It's good, Louis Bleachmore.
How about the big man extending his range? Good for his second, his 6 points of the game.
37-29 now. Stag shooting 5 from 11 behind the three-point arc.
Kind of like a revelation, if you will, compared to the first two nights.
Really is. Clark now. And his pass nearly stolen by Floyd, but Corey Washington gets it. Washington over to South. So, Randolph. Randolph, top of the key, guarded by Yetna. Randolph driving on Yetna. Randolph goes in, uncontrolled. Layup no good. So with the offensive rebound. His putback no good. Yetna corrals the board. Yetna gets it to Fields.
Smart play there by slowing it down.
Fields
up
to Leach. Leach pushing the pace. Leach, swoop layup with the right hand is good.
You see that elusiveness and explosiveness from Jalen Leach? He is back 4 points early for him in the second half.
39-29 now, Stags. 17 minutes, 15 seconds left. Latrell Reed working on Fields. Reed passes into Washington. Washington on the far wing. Now So. So top of the key guarded by Yetna. So calling over for Randolph. Randolph on the near wing. Now inside the Washington. Washington near the block. Washington going into the paint, goes up, a good shot over good defense by Jalen Leach.
Tough players make tough buckets. Corey Washington doing just that there.
39-31, Floyd now pushing the pace. Floyd in the paint, he's gonna get it outside, bounce past the Bleachmore. Bleachmore resets the Fields, Fields top of the key. Fields now, guarded by Reed. Reed, screened off by Bleachmore. Fields, step back three, that's altered. That shot was altered by Washington, and it will remain Peacock ball as Reed kept Yetna from trying to make a play on it after Yetna just touched it.
And St. Peter's is well aware of how prolific a three-point shooter Caleb Fields is. They're not taking any chances on him despite him just having 6 points so far.
So now we're seeing for the first time this half more that kind of soft press where Fields is at least tracking Latrell Reed up the court. Randolph over to So. So top of the key, guarded by Yetna. Now Reed guarded by Fields on the far wing. Washington near the baseline, guarded by Bleachmore. Washington driving on Bleachmore. He's going to be fouled, and he gets the and one. Corey Washington, the All-MAAC honoree, with a chance to complete the three-point play.
Slowly but surely, Corey Washington is coming alive. Stags have to put emphasis on him to keep this lead.
So Washington's already buried two free throws. He's 2-for-4 on the day, came into the game shooting a little bit over 81%. Bleachmore has committed two fouls this half. That's his third personal. James Johns Jr. checking into the game. Fairfield with three team fouls in the early going. St. Peter's with none. So Washington will go to the line for one. None of St. Peter's are currently in the box. This rebound, if missed, will go to Fairfield. It was missed, and yet in a uncontested, corrals the board.
4-of-8 from the line for St. Peter's now, not ideal.
39-33, Fairfield over St. Peter's. Johns Jr. hands off to Fields. Now Floyd. Floyd top of the key. Floyd drives to his left. Floyd working on so. Floyd working his pivot foot, trying to find anybody. He does. Finds Leach. Leach outside, gives it back to Floyd. Floyd on the far wing. Floyd driving with his right. Step back jumper from Floyd. Bounce off the front of the rim. No good. Rebound hauled in by Washington. Washington lost it after Yetna poked it. Washington grabbed the board. Yetna poked it loose. Washington tried to grab it from going out of bounds. It went off of Washington. It'll be Fairfield ball when we come back out of this official's timeout. Fairfield 39, St. Peter's 33. You're listening to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. There's 15 minutes, 45 seconds left in this half. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson. Logan Rundy, you did a phenomenal job calling the women's championship win over Niagara earlier. He's doing an even better job on stats tonight. It'll be Fairfield ball, 20 seconds left, 15 minutes, 45 seconds left here in the second half. Fairfield 39, St. Peter's 33. Andrew, what have you seen?
And Fairfield, they're shooting okay from the arc. From the field, 37% from the field, only 5 of 12 from 3, that's 42%, 60% from the free throw line. So it could be better, but it could be worse.
Floyd inbounds, they're going to get it to Leach. Leach now guarded by Washington. Leach thinks about stepping back. This time he pumps, then he does shoot, no good. But Fields tips it to himself for the offensive rebound. Fields drives, kicks, John Jr., corner three, short, no good. Roy Clark grabs the board. We have checking in for St. Peter's over the break. Stefan Roberts comes in for Mohamed Sal. It'll be Latrell Reed dribbling up the court over to Washington. Reed now. Reed guarded by Leach. Dribbles to his right now, guarded by Yetna after the switch. Reed, three, no good. And there will be a foul on the floor. It will be on Fairfield. Stephon Roberts drew the call. And that will be Jalen Leach's third personal foul, the fourth team foul of the half. Let's see what happens. Yeah, Jalen Leach was given what you would call a hug to Roberts on that one.
Yeah, not ideal for Leach. He picks up his third. He's got to be careful here.
So Reed now gives it to Roberts, who immediately gives it back to Reed. Reed sends it over to Rudolph. Randolph, top of the key, inside the Washington. Washington guarded by John Jr. Washington, the hook with the right hand. It's good. 39-35.
Fairfield trying to answer with a 2.5-minute scoring drought here. All of their last four from the field.
14 minutes and about 45 seconds and rolling. Here, Jim Whelan, Boardwalk Hall, Atlantic City. Defense chance uprise from the St. Peter's faithful. James John Jr. now. Caleb Fields gets it back to Jalen Leach at the top of the key. Leach dribbles to his left. Leach now going inside, worked over by Washington. Fadeaway, baseline jumper, no good. Yetna almost had the board but loses it. Moving with pace is Reed. Reed up the court with steam. There'll be a foul. It'll be a charge. James Johns Jr. sacrificed his body and forced the turnover.
Takes one for the team there in a big way. That disrupts for the moment a 6-0 run by the Peacocks. Nonetheless, the Stags need to step it up offensively here.
So now pressing are the Peacocks. James John Jr. will inbound. We're just going to wait for the court to be mopped. The mopping is concluded. So James John Jr. now, the inbounder. Looks, he'll get it in the fields. Fields now guarded by MAAC Defensive Player of the Year, Latrell Reed. Fields, working up court, gets across half court. Now Johns Jr. James Johns Jr. spinning, and he's fouled by Marcus Randolph. And once again, the St. Peter's faithful actually looking for a travel, not a foul. That'll be on Randolph. That'll be his first personal, the second team foul.
St. Peter's not thrilled about that one at all. Fairfield just has to move on in this hostile environment, honestly, I'm going to call.
So after that foul, Randolph will check out of the game. Checking into the game will be Brent Bland, the redshirt sophomore. Leach, the inbounder for Fairfield. He's going to get in the fields. Caleb Fields now over to James John Jr. John Jr. passes over to Yetna. Yetna. Leach. Leach. Out to Yetna. Yetna for three. Air ball. No good. Reed slipped as he grabbed the rebound, but maintains.
Not an ideal shot there from Yetna. He's had a hot hand, just not out of his range.
39-35 is the score now. 13 minutes, just about 45 seconds and rolling left here in the second half. Corey Washington now back to Roy Clark. Roy Clark stands on the logo. Clark dribbles to his right, thinks about pulling, instead drives to the rack. His layup rolls out, and there's about three different set of hands on the ball. It'll be a jump ball. Possession arrow will go towards Fairfield. Checking into the game, sixth man of the year, Bryson Goodine for the Stags. He will replace James John Jr.
Jalen Leach still in with three fouls. Coach Casey has the utmost confidence in the world in him. Only a trusted coach would keep his star player in with three fouls this early in the game.
James John Jr. leaves to a nice ovation from the Fairfield crowd that has traveled down south. Fields now dribbling the ball up the court. Hands off to Floyd. Floyd hands off to Leach. Leach now. Dribbling. Hands it back to Fields. Fields. Over to Leach. Leach. Dribbling. Driving. Kicks. And that pass is stolen. That is Brett Bland. Bland. The layup. Rejected by Goodine. But they're going to call a foul on Goodine, and Goodine can't believe it.
That's Goodine's third. That's two elite players for the Stags in foul trouble here.
So Leach was driving and kicking, and Brent Bland had other plans, and he took it down the court, and now he will shoot two. Bland has not shot today at the line. On the season, Bland's 73.1% free throw shooter.
Seems that the momentum is with St. Peter's now. Are they on a 6-0 run in the last almost 4 minutes?
So Bland getting ready to shoot the first of two. He bangs the first of two. Now, they're on now a 7-0 run over the last nearly 4 minutes. Jalen Leach checks out of the game, coming into the game, Louis Bleachmore. Fairfield holding a 3-point lead, 39-36. Bland looking to make it two. He does, 39-37, and now we have a substitution. Michael Hogue did not start the half, and now he will check in. He started the game, however. Stephon Roberts will head to the bench. Bleachmore for Fields. The five on the floor for Fairfield. Caleb Fields, Louis Bleachmore, Jasper Floyd, Bryson Goodine, Alexis Yetna. Fields hands it to Bleachmore, who fakes the handoff to Floyd. Fakes it again. Now Fields. Fields, top of the key. He's going to pull a three. Caleb Fields off the back of the rim. Gets his own rebound on the long rebound. Fields, scoop layup. It's good.
How about Fields following his own shot there, getting the much-needed two to end an 8-0 run by the Peacocks.
So the five on the court for the Peacocks now. Reed, Bland, Washington, Hogue, and Clark. Reed now. Fairfield 41, St. Peter's 37. Passes over to Bland. Bland back to Roy Clark. Clark at the top of the key. Reed on the far wing. Back to Clark, top of the key. Clark pumps. Shaky pass over to Reed, but Reed gets it. Now Bland. Bland pulls the three. Bland's three is good. 41-40.
Well, a seven lead, point lead at half is now just down to one.
Jasper Floyd, guarded by Roy Clark. Floyd gives it to Bleachmore. Fakes the handoff to Goodine. Bleachmore still holds. Back to Floyd. Floyd now. Floyd dribbles with his left. Floyd driving. Kicks out. Goodine. Three. Off the front of the rim. Rebound hauled in by Reed.
That's when Goodine's going to walk back there. He was wide open.
Slowing things down is Reed following Bashir Mason's direction. He's going to go back to Washington. Bland now. Michael Hogue. Hogue, top of the key, guarded by Floyd. Hogue is going to back down Floyd. Hogue trying to spin. His layup is good. St. Peter's has the lead. 42-41.
Fairfield struggling offensively, one of their last nine trying to get something here.
And after they cross half court, Chris Casey calls a timeout. The St. Peter's crowd erupts. St. Peter's on a 13-2 run over the last 5.5 minutes. They made 5 of their last 7 field goals. They now have a 1-point lead. We're going to take a quick break. Do not go anywhere. We are in for a thrilling finish here at Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jamison. Andrew, St. Peter's has come out of the gates flying here. They now have retaken the lead 42-41 with 11 minutes 23 seconds left here in the second half.
We said it right before the break, a 13-2 break over the last 5.5 minutes. Five of their last seven from the field. Fairfield, on the other hand, been ice cold. One of their last nine from the field, and it doesn't help that Leach, Goodine, and Bleachmore all have 3 fouls for the Stags.
So on the floor right now for the Stags is Yetna, Goodine, Floyd, Leach, and Fields. It's a generally small lineup. The four best guards Fairfield has, and Alexis Yetna, who has a double-double in what thus far has been his best game as a Stag. The five on the floor for St. Peter's will be Roy Clark, Corey Washington, Michael Hogue, Latrell Reed, and Brent Bland. The crowd on its feet. Fairfield inbounding the ball after taking a timeout. Fairfield has two timeouts left, St. Peter's three. Floyd inbound to the Fields. Fields has to take it back across half court. Does. Floyd now. Floyd top of the key. Floyd over to Fields. And it appears for the first time St. Peter's is running a zone. Pass inside to Floyd. Floyd backing down Hogue. Floyd spinning with the left hand off the glass. No good. Hogue with the rebound.
Nice defense there by Hogue.
Slowing things down now. Latrell Reed. Senior guard out of Willingboro, New Jersey. Third team All-MAC honoree. He passes into the corner, Roy Clark. Clark guarded by Goodine. Now back to Clark. Reed, top of the key. Clark now, inside the Hogue. Hogue, and that's a tough call is what that is. Yeah. That'll be on Alexis Yetna. So that'll be a shooting foul. Yetna had his hands right up in the air. And going up strong was Hogue. He drew the foul.
Looking at the Jumbotron, I did not see a reach there. His hands were up. Nonetheless, a foul here.
So this will be an official timeout after Chris Casey's timeout. So we're going to step aside for a moment. We will be right back. Don't go anywhere. You're listening to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM.
Too long before you point it out. I cannot cry because I know that's weakness in your eyes. I'm forced to fake a smile, a laugh every day of my life. My heart can't possibly break when it wasn't even whole to start with. Because of you, I never strayed to.
Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jamison, where the Fairfield Stags, at one point led by 10, now down by one, chasing their first NCAA title berth and the first MAAC championship win since 1997. But things have gone awry, and now going to the line to shoot two will be Michael Hogue. What did you see from St. Peter's that has slowed down the Stags?
Well, it's been a streaky game up to this point. St. Peter's has been absolutely dominating the paint, dominating the game in transition. 13-2 run over their last 6.5 minutes. Fairfield University has not been able to adapt well enough, and as a result, they have been outscored in the second half. Now find themselves down one, potentially three.
So coming out of the last timeout, both St. Peter's and Fairfield entered a zone defensively, which is something to know, and that time they got beat. And just to remind people what's at stake for the Stags, with the women winning the MAAC championship today, Fairfield has a chance to join Loyola, who did it in 1994, Manhattan, who did it in 2003, and Iona, who's done it twice in 2016 and 2023, as institutions to have won both the MAAC men's and women's basketball championships in the same season. Fairfield has 10.5 minutes to erase this one-point deficit and set and punch their ticket. And St. Peter's, on the other hand, the last time they were in the dance, everyone knows what happened in 21-22. Yeah. They went all the way to the Elite Eight.
And St. Peter's is not to be taken lightly. However, Fairfield needs to be disciplined here. Six fouls just about halfway through this second half. One more, and then it's 1-1 for St. Peter's the rest of the way.
Michael Hogue, 73.3% free throw shooter. His first free throw is good.
St. Peter's has increased their free throw percentage up from the first half, now 7 of 11 on the game.
part of the why Fairfield's lead has vanished is they're one for their last 10 from the field.
Not ideal.
Hogue going for his second. Misses. So it's 43-41, St. Peter's over the Stags. Jasper Floyd up the court. Peyton Smith has checked in the game for the Stags for Alexis Yetna. Otherwise, it's the same. Fields, Floyd, Leach, and Goodein. Leach now directing traffic at the top of the key. Passes over to Goodein. Goodein inside the Leach. Leach, bounce pass into Smith. Smith pumps and is fouled on the way up by Hogue. Peyton Smith to the line for two.
Nice patience there by Peyton Smith, waiting for the right moment to get a shot up, draws a foul, going to the line for two.
Peyton Smith, 0-for-3 shooting on the day. These will be his first free throws of the night, shooting 75.5% at the stripe this season. The freshman, he makes the first.
Peyton Smith had 9 points in that last game versus Marist, was huge off the bench.
Checking out of the game appears to be Michael Hogue. Checking into the game will be Muhammad So. Smith, the 6'10 freshman, 250 pounds out of Hudson Falls, New York, looking to go 2-for-2 at the line. Smith now. Bounces, no good. Rebound corralled by Corey Washington. 43-42 now, about to pass the halfway mark in the second half. Just about 10 minutes away from figuring out who will be winning the MAAC and moving on. Clark, Reed now. Reed, top of the key. Over to Bland. Bland, back out to Clark. Clark, now across to the far wing, Reed. Reed, Fairfield still in his zone. Reed, inside Washington. Washington working on Smith. Washington's two-handed slam!
Washington just lost Smith there. He was easiest bucket all night for two.
Hit him with a spin move and left Smith in the dust and yammed it home for pair. 45-42, St. Peter's. Leach with the ball. Sends Fields cutting. Fields finds a soft spot in the zone and nails the jumper from just inside the free throw line.
Beautiful dish there by Jalen Leach to find the open Fields for two.
45-44. Fairfield did a little more of a press now. Still nothing crazy, but a softer press. Reed. Over to Clark on the near wing, guarded by Goodein. Fields. Fairfield running a 3-2 zone. Inside now, Reed into Washington. Washington's layup is good. He had three Stags that bit on the pump fake.
Yeah, it looked like zero out there with how easy Washington was able to get that up.
47-44. Peacocks over the Stags. Floyd, handoff to Fields. Fields. He gives it to Goodein. Goodein drives with his left. Goodein pumps. Is going to pass it away. He will draw a foul on the play. And this foul will be on the floor. The foul committed by Brent Bland. Checking into the game. Actually, no one's checking into the game. Who am I kidding? St. Peter's, 14 fouls on the night. Fairfield, 6. Inbound to Peyton Smith. Now Leach. Leach driving with the right. Leach, crossover move into the paint. Leach spinning, goes up. Layup, it's rejected by Washington. Washington tracks on the board. Washington with pace. Corey Washington, the layup is good. The biggest lead of the game for St. Peter's, 49-44.
That's a textbook possession from start to finish for the Peacocks.
Bryson Goodein now. Goodein picks up his dribble, finds Jasper Floyd. Floyd, Leach, Leach top of the key. Leach drives, pull up, long two, jumper is good. 49-47.
Much needed there from your best scorer from the season. Leach gets it done when Fairfield needs it most.
About to surpass the 8-minute mark. 3-point lead for the Peacocks. Back in a man defense is Fairfield's. Roy Clark. He's going to give it over to Washington. Washington. Back to Clark. Clark. Top of the key. Dribbles. Guarded by Peyton Smith. Roy Clark, step back three. It's good. Roy Clark, the freshman out of Brooklyn with the big three.
The shooting is contagious right now, Ryan. St. Peter's 6 for your last 6.
To Peyton Smith. Smith driving inside on So. Smith loses the ball, but he's fouled on the play by So. So that is Muhammad So, first personal, 15 foul. That'll take us into an official's timeout. St. Peter's has a 6-point lead. Andrew, what's going on here?
St. Peter's just can't miss, Ryan. They're 6 of their last 6 on the field. Their shooting percentage on the game has skyrocketed to 49%. They're just making everything they put up right now.
We saw Fairfield try to adjust to a zone. That didn't work. They went back to a man. And as you mentioned, Andrew, they're just hitting all their shots. And Fairfield, eventually, they're going to start hitting their shots and get some stops.
Yeah, and Fairfield faced their largest deficit of the game at 6 currently with under 7.5 to go. Fairfield's going to have to match St. Peter's offensively and get stops. St. Peter's has been stout defensively. We just saw that emphatic block by Washington on Leach, and then he returned it to the for the dunk.
St. Peter's up 6, at one point down 10. Now, we saw on the flip side last night, Fairfield down 11 to Marist. They came back and won. We know this Fairfield team has resolve, but can they show it tonight? That is to be seen. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Fairfield University, Student Radio, 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson, Logan Rundy on stats. St. Peter's has surged this second half to a 52-46, a six-point lead. The five on the floor for Fairfield. Yetna checks back in the game. Caleb Fields, Bryson Goodine, Jalen Leach, and Jasper Floyd. The five on the floor for St. Peter's. Latrell Reed, Stephon Roberts, Roy Clark, Corey Washington, and Brent Bland. The inbound is successful. Fields drives, scoop layup, right hand, it's good. 52-48.
Much needed coming out of that media timeout to get some momentum back, trying to tame off this scorching defense.
Floyd pokes the ball loose, and that's going to be a jump ball. That is pure effort and a great press by the Stags. It will remain St. Peter's ball, but a great job by Jasper Floyd to force the jump.
And they need this type of effort if they want to get back into this game, but they need to do it in a smart manner because they are at 16 fouls. One more and St. Peter's is in the bonus.
And on the flip side, St. Peter's with 5. And St. Peter's is going to take a 30-second timeout. So we're to take a quick break. We'll be right back on the other end of this timeout. Welcome back after that quick break to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jameson. Part of the reason why head coach Bashir Mason took the timeout is there is 3 seconds left. The Peacocks have 3 seconds to get the ball over half court to avoid the backcourt violation. What will the Stags do? Will they continue to press? I would assume they would to try and force a turnover.
They need to ramp up the defensive intensity, but of importance without fouling. As we mentioned right before the break, St. Peter's one foul away from that bonus, which can get things out of hands quicker if St. Peter's continues to knock down free throws.
Inbounding the ball, Washington. Reed and Clark in the backcourt with him. They get it in the Reed. Reed holds, 20 seconds pass by, but as the timeout goes, it's not a backcourt violation anymore. Reed now pinched. He's going to pass it quickly. Now back to Roy Clark. They're going to settle things down. Clark, 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Get it out to Washington. 5 on the shot clock. Washington, far away from the three-point line. Washington now drives to the left. Leach pokes at it. Contest the shot is good. What an acrobatic shot from Corey Washington.
Yeah, Washington's just cooking right now. He's up to 20 points on the game, 16 in the second half alone.
54-48, this has been the Washington takeover. Fields now drives with his left, step back. Gives it to Yetna at the top of the key. Yetna to Leach. Leach to Goodine. Goodine pump fakes for a three. Dribbles to his right. Goodine driving with his right. He's going to go up. He's going to get fouled. He will be, they will say he's in the act of shooting, and that will be on Brent Bland. And I believe that is his fourth personal. That's the team's sixth of the half.
So
Goodine, 1 for 2 at the stripe tonight.
One more for each team, and will be 1 and 1 for either team.
Checking into the game for St. Peter's will be Marcus Randolph. Checking out of the game will be Bland, as he is one more foul away from fouling out of this contest. Goodine came into the game 76% from the line. He's 1 for 2 tonight. Just made that one. 54-49 is the score.
Yeah, Goodine with a lackluster performance here tonight. 4 points, 1 of 7. Actually, take that back. 5 points, 1 of 7 from the field, 1 of 4 from three.
Goodine, someone the Stags desperately need to get hot, makes the second of two. 54-40 now. Stags still pressing. Roy Clark, guarded by Floyd. Floyd. They're going to double-team Clark behind the half-court line. They're going to get it across. Reed now to Washington. Washington, top of the key, kicks it out. Open three. Randolph, it's good! The Peacocks cannot miss.
8 of their last 8. Now Ryan took the words right out of my mouth.
57-50. Fields now. Yetna gets it to Floyd. Floyd drove inside. He's going to recalibrate. Floyd, step back three. Bounces off the rim. Washington hauls in the rebound.
Good rebound there by Washington. Physical but smart.
5 minutes, 45 seconds and rolling left. And that's going to be a foul on Caleb Fields. That'll be his second personal. And now they're going to go to the line for a 1 and 1. We're entering crunch time here, Andrew. And St. Peter's already in the bonus.
Yeah,
and
St. Peter's hasn't missed, so it's not looking great for our Stags right now. You can never count this team out, but the Peacocks are just keeping the foot on the gas.
It's hard to win games when you go on runs where you go 8 for 8 shooting. Latrell Reed comes into the game shooting 64% from the line. These will be his first attempts of the night. Reed. First shot is good, so he earns a second. 58-50 is the score. Fairfield, St. Peter's, both with 2 timeouts left.
Reed now up to 8 points on the game. St. Peter's, 8 of 13 from the line.
Reed, his second free throw is good. 59-50. Caleb Fields takes the ball up court. Fields keeps it. Goes baseline. Working on Reed, kicks it out. Goodine, the three. No good. Rebound goes off Leach's foot into Fields' hands. Fields, his three off the front of the rim, no good. He pokes the rebound out to Floyd. Floyd now, Fields, Goodine, pumps, Goodine, another attempt from three, no good. Getting that tips it out to Fields. The fourth go at it. Goodine, Floyd. Floyd on the far wing. Floyd dribbles across to the top of the key. Jasper Floyd, Caleb Fields now. Fields to the near wing. Passes back to Floyd. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Floyd spinning. Inside pass. Yetna. Layup is good.
3 offensive rebounds on that possession there. Boy, were they needed, though. Fairfield trying to cut into this lead 1 bucket at a time.
They had to walk out with something. 59-52. Stags pressing. Reed now guarded by Fields in the backcourt. Fields letting him get across half court now. Reed is going to hand it off to Washington. Corey Washington to Marcus Randolph. Randolph picks up his dribble, sends it to Washington. Washington guarded by Goodine. Washington on the far wing. Still working on Goodine. Shot clock at 5. Washington, step back, 3 off the front of the rim, but it's a foul. Bryson Goodine fouls. That'll be his 4th personal.
Not an ideal foul there by Goodine. This is the last member of the Peacocks you want to send to the line for 3 freebies.
So the one time they miss, he gets fouled. St. Peter's faithful on their feet. Washington 2 of 5 from the free throw line, which is uncharacteristic. He's about an 81.5% free throw shooter coming into the game. Washington with a chance to extend the lead. Back up to 10. His first free throw is no good. So for as well as Washington shooting from the field, not shooting well from the stripe. 2 of 6 on the day.
Fairfield needs any miss right now. They will need it to get back into this game.
St. Peter's is shooting an unbelievable 71% from the field in the second half. Fairfield, on the other hand, shooting 36% in the second half from the field. And Washington misses the second. 2 of 7 from the day. Checking into the game for Latrell Reed will be Brent Bland. Now remember, Bland has 4 personal fouls. Next one and he is done.
Goodine
Washington
also has
smiling
four.
In disbelief. Washington trying to salvage something. He doesn't. He goes 0 for 3 at the line.
Wow.
So Floyd gets the board. Floyd, Fields for 3. No good. It rims out. Rebound Randolph. Randolph thought about slinging it up ahead of Washington and said, we'll slow it down. 4 minutes, 5 seconds left and running here in the MAAC championship. Over to Washington. Washington guarded by Floyd. Washington hands off to Randolph. Floyd almost stole it. Now it's Roy Clark. Roy Clark hits a screen. Roy Clark drives on Yetna. Roy Clark's layup is good. The contested lay.
Better offense there over good defense.
61-52. Floyd. Leach. Leach drives with his right. Top of the key now. Leach. Crossover. 3. No good. They can't buy one from deep. Can the Stags? And Roy Clark gets the board.
Yeah, Stags not shooting well. Now
Fields gets a loose ball, and that's going to be a foul on the floor. And that'll go against the Peacocks. It'll go against Roy Clark. So that'll be Roy Clark's third personal. Caleb Fields is going to go to the line for a 1-on-1 situation. 9 for their last 9 are the Peacocks on the field.
Fairfield, 1 of their last 7 in return.
Folks, that's how you lose leads, when the other team shoots 9 for 9 with a bunch of them being threes, and Fairfield right now in a scoring rut and not shooting well. In the first half, it was so pleasant they were shooting well because they hadn't shot well all tournament, and now in the second half, the bugaboos have come back.
The reoccurring nightmare, yes, just unfortunately for them, St. Peter's just cannot miss, as we saw on the Jumbotron. 71% from the second half, St. Peter's making it count when it matters most.
We currently have a long court putt, similar to what happens at Leo D. Mahoney Arena. They get 3 opportunities to put it through the board. The first one, very far wide. The second one,
that's
with a little
left.
More pace, but way far left. Maybe the third time will be the charm. And for Fairfield, they need this break to be the charm. 3.5 minutes left. They're down 9. Their season's on the line. This third putt, no good. So the third time wasn't the charm for our contestant. Fairfield hoping, on the other hand, that this break is exactly what they need to try and stop the bleeding.
Yeah, and Fairfield just needs anything to go their way. You have to start here with these 2 free throws by Caleb Fields. 1 possession at a time. No buckets. You can't miss buckets if you're Fairfield.
And it starts with making your free throws, right? Like, Corey Washington missed 3 big free throws. He had a chance to put this game in the double digits, and he did not. Letting a team like Fairfield linger around, as we know, we've said it before, they live and die by the 3. It only takes a couple to get them right back in this game. Both teams with 2 timeouts left. This game far from over, but St. Peter's thus far has mounted an impressive comeback, and the tides have completely turned.
Yeah, outscoring the Stags by 16 in this second half after being down 7 in the first. So you have to give credit to St. Peter's for their resilience and tenacity.
And the engine of the team, as it's been all year, Corey Washington, the sophomore, leading St. Peter's with 20 points and 8 rebounds. He is named first team All-MAAC for a reason, and he did not play in St. Peter's and Fairfield's second matchup this season. He's making his presence felt tonight.
He absolutely is. And on the other hand, for the Stags, Yetna and Fields lead the way in scoring with 12 apiece. However, Jalen Leach has been held to 6 on 3 of 8 shooting.
The Stags, 5 of 22 from 3. On the other hand, St. Peter's, 6 of 13. So we're to come back. The Fairfield faithful trying to give a cheer and rally their team back from a 9-point deficit. 3 minutes, 28 seconds left. The five on the floor for Fairfield. Floyd, Leach, Goodine, Yetna, and Fields. The five for St. Peter's. Reed, Randolph, Washington, Roberts, and Clark. So this will be a one-on-one situation for Caleb Fields.
To line for Fairfield, shooting 101. Number zero, Caleb Fields.
Fields now.
To make it.
This is a must-make. He does. So he'll get to shoot another. 61-53 now. 3 minutes, 28 seconds left. Fields with 13 points of the night. He's 5 of 16 from the field. He makes a second.
Calm, cool, and collected from the line. There, Caleb Fields gets it done when he needed to most.
Lead cut to 7. Fairfield pressing. Now sent over to Clark. Clark doubled by Goodine and Fields. He turns it over, and Jalen Leach is going to get an easy layup.
That's just what the doctor ordered, Ryan. Jalen Leach there to pick it off. Easy two.
61-56 now. Fairfield still pressing. They're going to try and inbound this ball again. They're going to get it to Clark. They're going to double Clark. This time back to Randolph. Randolph now worked over by Goodine. Reed doubled. He's going to get over to Randolph. Now up to Washington on the wing. Washington's going to settle it back down to Reed.
St. Pierre's got to slow the pace here.
Reed over to Clark. Peacocks lead the Stags by 5. Just under 3 minutes left. Clark guarded by Goodine. He's going to dribble to his right and get a screen. Clark now guarded by Yetna. Clark with the shot clock at 5. Crosses over on Yetna, goes baseline, and the pass is going to be tipped by Jasper Floyd. There is going to be 1 second left on the shot clock.
Great defense there by the Stags to force errant passes, and not great communication there by the Peacocks. 1 second on the shot clock, as Ryan just said.
So St. Peter's will inbound. They have to get the shot off quick. Reed the inbounder. Looking. He's going to send it. It's going to be an attempt for an oop or a tip. Yetna grabs it out of the air. It's a loose ball. Leach picks it up. Stags have possession. Leach across half court. Leach guarded by Roberts. Now it's a Fields. Fields at the top of the key. Caleb Fields guarded by the MAAC Defensive Player of the Year, Latrell Reed. Fields over to Leach. Leach pumps. Step back. 3 for Leach. No good. Rebound Caleb Fields. Fields back out. Leach pumps. Gets out the Goodine. Goodine driving. He's going to pass it. He should have taken the layup. Instead, gets to the Yetna. Yetna's hook with the hook with the left hand. No good. That's Bryson Goodine inexplicably did not shoot that ball.
Yeah, I don't know what was going through his head there. Nonetheless, that's going to be what he wants back.
He was wide open and instead passed it to Yetna, who could not convert on the contested layup. So now it's Peacock's ball. Under 2 minutes left, Peacock's lead by 5. Roy Clark driving on Yetna. Clark falls down. Yetna keeps it in bound. Caleb Fields pushing the pace for Fairfield now. Fields finds Jasper Floyd, who gives it to Goodine. Goodine loses it, regains. Goodine driving with his left. He lays it in with his left. It's good this time.
Takes the layup that
the three.
One time game.
Out St. Peter's.
Here we go. Stags have momentum. This Fairfield faithful is going crazy.
Fairfield crowd on their feet as they have cut this lead down to 3. 1 minute, 39 seconds left. We're not going anywhere. Fairfield with a little bit of life. Andrew, what do they need to do defensively to keep St. Peter's flustered?
We saw the press work. It has worked. We need to continue to do it to get the ball back and potentially tie this game. Defense first, though. Only a minute 40 left. Vital here.
Fairfield, this team does not quit. They haven't all season long. They started 1-6 and went on a torrid run throughout the last three quarters of the season to find themselves right here in the championship game. There's a minute 39 seconds left. Fairfield's down 3. They're used to this. They've been built in these situations all season long. St. Peter's, on the other hand, we know they have big game experience. This is a program that was in the Elite 8 not more than since the 2021-2022 season. There, you know they're going to be ready for this. Corey Washington has been playing fantastic tonight. What do you expect them to do to try to break the press?
I think St. Peter's is going to do short dynamic passes, try and split this press. Whether it's through bounce passes or lollipops, any means necessary to not force a turnover.
So Fairfield's 6-0 run has cut the lead to 3. St. Peter's with 1 timeout left, Fairfield with 2. Fairfield has 18 fouls, St. Peter's with 7. Both teams in the bonus.
Ball security has been an issue for the Peacocks as of late. 4 turnovers in their last 2 minutes and 8 seconds have not scored in that time frame.
So we're going to have a substitution for St. Peter's. Muhammad So will check back into the game. He'll be with Corey Washington, Latrell Reed, Marcus Randolph, and Roy Clark. For the Stags, it'll be Alexis Yetna, Jalen Leach, Caleb Fields, Bryson Goodein, and Jasper Floyd. So starting with the ball now will be St. Peter's. They're up three. Fairfield continuing the press. They had a layup off of it earlier. This arena is on its feet.
Rightfully so.
And they're going to give the Washington tip ball. It's a loose ball. The ball's too loose. They're going to call a foul on the play. And they're going to call it on Jasper Floyd on the floor.
I don't know why.
The Fairfield faithful cannot believe it.
Washington leaned with his shoulder. I don't know how that's a foul on Floyd.
I don't know if they're going to be reviewing this. Regardless, Washington shooting free throws. But picture this. In the NFL, when a defensive back is trying to break up a pass and both he and the wide receiver get there at the same time. Well, that's what happened. And Floyd is going to get popped for the foul here. Now, Washington, theoretically coming into the game, would not be the guy you'd want to foul. 81.5% shooter coming into the game. But tonight, he's 2-for-8 at the line, including going 0-for-3 his last trip. So yeah. Here's Washington.
I don't know what's going to happen, Ryan.
Peacock's up 3. Minute 39 left. His first free throw. It's a 1-and-1. No good. It's off the top of the backboard. The rebound's loose. It's a loose ball. Fairfield ball.
Wow. Wow.
And it looks like they may be reviewing this. Referees are gathering. We have some A-level drama here at the Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City. This has been a phenomenal MAAC tournament for both the women's and men's. This is a fitting end. So we are going to take a break, and we are going to see if this will remain Fairfield's ball. Washington missed the free throw, but it was a loose ball, and everyone put their bodies on line. We're unsure who went off of. We're going to take a quick break. There's a minute 37 left in this game. St. Peter's has a three-point lead. Do not go anywhere. You're listening to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp, alongside me, Andrew Jameson, Logan Rundy on stats. The referees still reviewing who this was last out on. And generally speaking, when a review goes this long, they tend to stick with the call that was made on the floor. The call on the floor was Fairfield ball. We're going to wait to see what the referees say. Both teams still in a huddle. And the call is, as we wait the referees to walk to center court. Before we wait on what the call is, though, St. Peter's has turned the ball over 4 times in the last 2 minutes and 10 seconds.
Definitely has 2 turnovers all game and somehow find themselves at a disadvantage.
The referees just walked out the half court, and now 2 different ones have walked back to check this again. They want to make sure they get this right. The cheers you hear from the crowd are different sections of the fans being shown and celebrating when they are shown. This has been an absolutely electrifying crowd here at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall tonight with both fan bases into it. So, it will remain Fairfield ball. Fairfield gets it. So that is absolutely massive. Now St. Peter's is pressing. It'll be Leach, Fields, Floyd, Goodein, and Yetna, the same 5.
Goodein playing with 4 fouls, important to note.
For St. Peter's, you have Washington, Reed, Clark, Randolph. So, Fields gets the inbound. Guarded by Reed. Minute and a half left. Fields across half court. Fields now drives with his right. He's going to get to the Goodine. Goodine on the near wing. Goodine drives with his left. Inside. Goodine working on Clark. He pivots. His right baby hook is good.
He took advantage of that layup. He took it and he made it. Stags down one.
61-60. St. Peter's looking to inbound the ball. They've struggled to do this. They throw a lob pass to nobody. Washington gets it, and Yetna fouls Washington. And if he didn't, it was going to be an easy layup.
8-0 run for the Stags the last 2 minutes and 10 seconds.
That will be Alexis Yetna's, I believe, his fourth personal foul. And Washington will go to the line for two.
I honestly don't know what Washington's going to do anymore at the line. We tell you he's an 81.5% free throw shooter, which on the game he's just 2 of 9.
We mentioned the struggles for Washington tonight. 2 of 9. They're up by 1 in the big moments. Yetna, by the way, the scoreboard is incorrect. Yetna has 2 personal fouls, not 4, 2. So here's Washington. 2 of 9 from the line tonight. Makes it. 3 of 10.
That was his most clutch one when he needed it most.
St. Peter's 62, Fairfield 60. A minute and 7 seconds left. St. Peter's 10 of 19 from the line tonight. Washington makes the second. St. Peter's regains their 3-point lead. Leach the inbounder, trying to find somebody, anybody, they have to call a timeout.
Had to do what you had to do there, Jalen Leach.
So Fairfield now has one timeout remaining, as does St. Peter's, but the fact that they couldn't get the ball in there, not ideal. An absolute nail-biter here in Atlantic City. This has been an unbelievable game, and once again, we want to thank you for spending part of your Saturday night with us. Now, here's a weird contrast for St. Peter's. They've made 9 of their last 9 field goals. However, they've made a field goal in 2 minutes and 40 seconds.
Yeah, I don't know what to make of that stat. It's just two ends of the spectrum trying to meet somewhere in the middle. But Fairfield currently sits at a 3-point deficit, a minute and 7 seconds to go. This one is still up in the air.
Both teams' largest runs of the game have been 8-0. The Stags, at one point, had a 10-point lead, and a comeback would have been considered by St. Peter's prep. But if Fairfield pulls this one out, it's going to be to talk about how Fairfield pulled off the insurmountable or the improbable comeback. It'll be the same 5 on the floor for Fairfield. And it'll be the same 5 on the floor for St. Peter's. Leach the inbounder. Minute and 7 seconds left. St. Peter's pressing. Leach will be guarded by Washington and getting the pass in. Goodine guarded by Marcus Randolph. Floyd guarded by Roy Clark. Leach looking to throw a football pass. Instead gets in the Fields. Fields to Floyd. Jasper Floyd, Stags down 3. Just under a minute left now. Floyd, crossover move to the top of the key. He's going to get it to Leach. Leach guarded by Clark. Leach for 3. No good off the glass. Rebound Randolph. And they're going to get Yetna on the call. Yetna on the reach in after Randolph grabbed the board. And Randolph runs down to the other side of the court, getting ready to shoot free throws.
Yeah, Randolph appeared to look like he got poked in the eye there. Leach got the shot he wanted, just couldn't get it to fall.
So Marcus Randolph will head to the line. Randolph 2 for 2 at the line today. On the season coming into today, Randolph a 69% free throw shooter. He's shooting 2, regardless of what happens on the first. Marcus Randolph with a chance to make this a 2-possession game. Randolph, the first one. No good.
St. Peter's now 11 of 21 from the line today.
The free throw woes continue. St. Peter's just made about 75% of their free throws today. This game would be out of reach. They have not. They are 11 of 21 on the night, and Randolph makes the second. 64-60 is the score, 50.9 seconds left. And another timeout for the Stags.
Stags are out of timeouts
twice
now.
Twice now, they have not been able to inbound the ball after a made free throw and have had to burn 2 timeouts. So that leaves Fairfield without a timeout with 50.9 seconds left while St. Peter's has 1 remaining. Actually, excuse me, this is an official's timeout. Actually, just kidding, I was right the first time. So it is a Fairfield timeout. The possession arrow, if needed, goes in the line of Fairfield. Now, Andrew, you do not need to force a 3 here. You're only down 4. 50.9 seconds left, plenty of time. As we mentioned, the Peacocks struggling at the free throw line tonight.
No, you need a bucket, and you need a bucket quick. The last thing you can do is have St. Peter's have the shot clock off. So they need a quick 2-for-1 here. They need a bucket, and they need a bucket fast.
Who would you go to if you were Chris Casey?
I think you have to go to Caleb Fields. He's your leading scorer on the night already. I know he's just 5 of 16 from the field, 1 of 6 from 3. However, he has been your saving grace so far in this Atlantic City tournament. You have to go to your best players in March.
The crowd as into it as ever. Fairfield 60, St. Peter's 64. The 5-seed St. Peter's looking to not only upset number 1-seed Quinnipiac in the semis, but looking to pull off the upset on number 2-seeded Fairfield to send themselves back in to the big dance and make themselves MAAC champions once again. Can't speak enough about the crowd tonight, Andrew. They've been in it from the tip.
Yeah, phenomenal crowd. As of for the whole tournament, from game 1 to game 20, this crowd has showed up and showed out. Thank you all for listening and coming to Atlantic City to support your MAAC teams.
The 5 on the floor for the Peacocks: Washington, Roy Clark, Marcus Randolph, Latrell Reed, and Sapp. It's Leach, Floyd, Fields, Goodine, Yetna. This time they get the inbound. Fields hands it to Floyd. 45 seconds left. Floyd now dribbles across half court. Floyd hands it to Fields. Fields turns with his right hand hard into the paint. His layup, it falls, and that's an and one for Caleb Fields. He's going to have a chance at a three-point play and make it a one-point game.
Big-time players make big-time plays, Ryan. I sound like a broken record, but my wish came to fruition, if you will.
Roy Clark's feet were not set. Caleb Fields with the balance and the concentration to find the back of the net. Fields 3-for-4 at the line today, 74% on the season. Caleb Fields, if he makes this, can cut the deficit to 1. A massive free throw for the grad student. Fields buries it. 64-63 now.
Fields up to 17 now on the game, leading the Stags in scoring.
We mentioned both teams right now are struggling with the press. What will St. Peter's do? Inbounding the ball, Marcus Randolph. He gets it in. Reed now gets it back to Randolph. Randolph back to Reed. Reed's going to get it across half court. Reed guarded by Fields. Fields with a pickpocket. 30 seconds left. Peacocks up 1. Randolph with the ball. There's about an 8-second difference, 9-second difference between shot and game clock. Randolph now guarded by Floyd. Clark guarded by Goodine. 10 seconds left in on the shot clock. Now down to 5. Clark driving, and that's going to be on the floor. And that'll be, I believe, on Bryson Goodine. And Bryson Goodine has just fouled out of this game. So the Fairfield Sixth Man of the Year is going to take the seat.
Who do you think they're going to put in? They're going to go to Smith, Johns Jr., Bleachmore?
Unless the scoreboard is incorrect, and it has been tonight already. So you know what? That was Goodine's 4th, not his 5th. The scoreboard, once again, has been incorrect. So stepping to the line for 2 will be Roy Clark. Clark now, 76.1% on the season. Rattles around the first one home, 65-63.
Huge free throw there.
Huge free throw. Massive free throw here. There's 15 seconds left, and this completely dictates what Fairfield is going to do. Are they going to go for a 2, or are they going to go for a 3? Clark now shooting his 2nd free throw of the night, trying to go 2-for-2. Clark's free throw is good. Fairfield down 3, 15 seconds left. They struggle to get the ball in.
No
Leach
timeouts.
Leach is out of hurry. Leach looking for anybody, finds Floyd. Clock's ticking. Floyd is going to take it across half court. 10 seconds. Jasper Floyd into the wing. Floyd looking for somebody. Floyd for 3. No good. Washington with the rebound. He's fouled by Jalen Leach. St. Peter's is erupting. They're a few seconds away from going back to the big dance. Floyd was trying to offload and couldn't find anybody. Was open. Turned around. He was on the far wing and couldn't bring it home.
Unfortunate there for Floyd, who has been good from three-point land today, 2-of-4.
Shooting 2 now will be Corey Washington. We mentioned his struggles at the line. Fairfield has missed their last 14 three-point attempts. Washington with a chance to seal the deal here. He's got 2 shots. He just needs to make 1. Washington, 4-for-11 on the day at the line. He makes it. St. Peter's up 4. 2.9 seconds left. Jubilation among the St. Peter's faithful. Washington now looking for a second. It looks like he's trying to intentionally miss this.
To run the clock.
Washington's second attempt, he makes it. So Fairfield down five, 2.9 seconds left. The inbound, Fields is going to chuck it up. And St. Peter's is going back to the dance. Congratulations to the Peacocks.
Congratulations to the Peacocks indeed. They were underdogs this whole tournament, coming in as a 5 seed. Well deserved there. However, we have to give credit to both sides. Our Fairfield Stags showed up and showed out, fought adversity all season, started 1-6 on the year. A great season, and Coach Casey has these boys headed in the right direction.
The Peacocks down 10, surge back to make their second NCAA tournament and their second MAAC championship in 3 years.
Have to give credit where credit is due once again, as St. Peter's was the better team in the second half.
This is the fifth MAAC championship in St. Peter's school history. Corey Washington was absolutely sensational tonight, Andrew.
Yes, he was. 24 points. We can look at the 6 of 13 from the free throw line all we want, but when it mattered most, Corey Washington came through clutch and sealed this game for the Peacocks. Rightful selection for all first team in the MAAC.
The Peacocks had a stretch during the second half where they went 9 of 9 from the field. And while it got close, the lead was cut to 1 at one point. It was never close enough.
Well, it's hard to lose when the opponent goes 9 of 9 from the field, and St. Peter's shooting above 70% in that second half. Absolutely phenomenal showing, and they have earned this celebration in every way.
So for WVOF, I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson, Logan Rundy on stats. The three of us, we did 6 games this week. We watched the Fairfield women win, and they will be booking their ticket to the big dance. The Fairfield men's not as fortunate. St. Peter's are 2023-2024 MAAC champions. Thank you very, very much for spending your Saturday evening with us, but more importantly, for tuning in all season long. This has been an unbelievable season to cover. We thank you very, very much from the bottom of our hearts. It has been special for all of us to be able to go to Atlantic City this week and to be able to do these broadcasts.
From myself, Ryan Canfield, Logan Rundy, our WVOF broadcast team, entire community back at Fairfield, thank you, Fairfield faithful, for showing up, showing out, listening to our broadcast, attending the home games. It has been nothing short of a pleasure to cover this season for everyone.
And for the final time covering men's basketball, we thank you for tuning in to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jameson. Logan Rundy signing off. Thank you, and have a good night.